World League on USA is brought to you by Kentucky Fried Chicken. Nobody's cooking like today's KFC. By the Reebok pumps, pump up and air out. And by Coors Light, the one that won't slow you down. The silver bullet is the right beer now.
The state capitol, built in 1840 in one of five original squares in the city of Raleigh, North Carolina. We have a late arriving crowd tonight, filing in on what has turned in to be a beautiful night. It was muggy and rainy most of today in the triangle area of North Carolina, but a very pleasant night. The humidity has dropped 70 degrees. The wind has picked up. It's natural grass. What more can you ask for, Dave?
It's beautiful. We came in yesterday and it was cloudy, raining. I thought, well, it's going to be a rough night tonight, but it's turned out just beautiful. And as you said, beautiful night for football.
Now, here's something I know that you, for years, strove to be introduced through dry ice, didn't you?
It's like going to a rock concert.
Absolutely.
As you see, the hometown Raleigh-Durham Skyhawks being introduced. It has been a tough time for Roman Gabriel. They've had so many injury problems. They've had to delve into Team Dallas, the World League replacement team, more heavily than any of the 10 World League franchises thus far. And I guess Roman Gabriel will be the first guy to tell you there's nothing that a win wouldn't solve.
You know, the toughest thing is just getting that first win. If it takes a while, it does take a while. We're looking at Mike Riley, the coach from San Antonio, but he was telling us just getting that first win took a lot of pressure off his back, and Roman Gabriel's going through the same thing. Just get that first one, and things become a lot easier.
Well, Mike Riley coached the Winnipeg Blue Bombers to two Grey Cup championships, yet he said that thrill was matched by his first World League win last week.
It really felt good to win. It felt like it had been a long time, and we had a little bit of a monkey on our back, and it was good to win, and now it's very, very important for us to build on that win and get better this week.
Of course, what Mike Riley has in his favor, a very good defense. Their defense has been stingy, held Sacramento to just one first down in the second half last week, and that is what Roman Gabriel's hoping his team can develop into, a defense that can stop somebody.
Well, they've given up a lot of points, Raleigh-Durham has, and that's one thing you got to do. You got to be able to keep the other team from getting into your own end zone. And so far, take a good look at Roman Gabriel. They have not been able to do that. They've been run on well. Last week, Barcelona, 186 yards on the ground.
Well, a gentleman who had a long and distinguished National Football League career as a quarterback, now starting a franchise from scratch.
It seems like anything the first time is the toughest. Even when you met your first girlfriend and got married, that was tough. But this might be even more so because you're dealing with more than just one. You're dealing with so many young people, and you're dealing with an inexperienced ball club. You're dealing basically, too, with not an inexperienced staff, but a staff together for the first time. Everything is new, and it is tough. It's difficult, and I think that I'm battling.
Joe Henderson, Steve Avery, Phil Ross, the tight end, Boyer, and Mobley, his two key wide receivers, the offensive front, Mullen, Tank, Anderson, Inagaz, and Buddy King. And first down, the fire from its own 20-yard line. And the give on the ground, and a gain of maybe a yard and a half for Joe Henderson before he's all stacked up by Roy Hart. And they call it the heart attack defense for the Monarchs, and Roy Hart is the guy in the middle. Boomer's already talked about him, the nose tackle there with Renna, who had three sacks last week, and John Shannon. The linebacking core, Brown, Solly, Williams, and Lockett, who leads the league in sacks. Smith, Irvin, Dodge, and Dan Crossman, who you'll see all over the field tonight, rounding out the secondary for the Monarchs.
On mute.
Picking it would probably be the last thing to come around because you just can't spend the time on it. You're trying to get your offenses together, your defenses together. As a result, your special teams do take a little bit of a back seat. Now, Wilson Hoyle will kick off. And right away, we're going to find out about this running game, because we talked about it a little earlier. San Antonio, a great running team, and that to me is the key tonight.
And San Antonio wearing the white jerseys with brown and gold trim. Raleigh-Durham is in red with white numbers and green trim. And Broderick Graves and Undra Johnson are two of the deep backs. As Hoyle puts the ball on the tee. A very strong college area. This beautiful area of North Carolina, the Skyhawks introducing professional football to Raleigh-Durham. And hoping tonight that they can bring home their first win. And Hoyle approaches it, and we're underway. Low line drive, fielded by Dwight Pickens, who drops it inside the 10. And crosses the 20 on the return. And in on the tackle, as we see Mike Johnson, Operation Discovery.
Right,
I was going to say Vladimir Georgiev, one of the Soviet players from Operation Discovery, was in on the tackle. Mike Johnson, a left-handed quarterback who played for 2 years for Jerry Faust at Akron. Came from Team Dallas, the skill position people. Ricky Blake, fourth in the World League in rushing, and Ronnie Williams, a good tight end. John Vitale, former Michigan center, anchors the offensive line. Sean Woodson, untouched.
This is also an area where you can really get some damage going, as San Antonio going with a no huddle. Inside from the left side of your screen, the backer comes in. Now, just untouched. Send in your linebackers. You'd have tough time with the pickups on the blitz.
Three wide receivers in for the Riders. Second and 18. And they give it to Blake. Ricky Blake is out across the 25. Raff Wilkinson on the tackle for the Skyhawks, as you look at their front three. The front seven for Raleigh-Durham really is going to have to assert themselves and play tougher.
Have not played well to date, especially the outside backers. They're getting hooked on the outside runs.
And their secondary, their best secondary man's not starting. Ray Jackson leads them in tackles. We're facing third and seven for San Antonio. Flags down. Alexander Johnson deals through the hands. Just shy of the first down marker. Intended receiver was John Garrett from Princeton, number 88. And here's the flags.
Defense, number 29, offside.
And there's a bad penalty. Defensive back Gerald Mack lining up offside.
You know, we talked about the running game being important. What does San Antonio do on the first play? They come out and pass, they get sacked, and now Raleigh-Durham trying to make a change on the fly. They might not be ready.
See how quickly the Riders get to the line. It's now third down and two. Ball to San Antonio 31, and they run it, and Blake spins to the right and gets the first down. Ricky Blake played 2 years of junior college football. He then went to Alabama A&M, but never played it down there. Left school early, never played football, went right to Canada and played for Mike Riley in Winnipeg.
And the no huddle for San Antonio. There's Blake.
See Blake with those numbers. The fourth best in the World League. Of Ricky Blake driving near another Riders first down at the 45 before Zeke Gadsden, 52, made the tackle for the Skyhawks.
One thing that Raleigh-Durham has done, they've moved one of their inside backers up on the line in anticipation of the run, but there's a nice old missed tackle. How many hits? Two, three.
Dave, that was a real problem for the Skyhawks against Paul Palmer in Barcelona last week.
Can't tackle, you can't win.
Now four wide receivers in on second down and short yardage. And the quick pass is grabbed by the tight end, Ronnie Williams. And he is down to the the 40-yard line of Raleigh-Durham. Raleigh-Durham did not adjust well. As we look at Williams, a tight end, he split out a little bit, was not picked up, and doing a good job. Of course, Mike Johnson hitting Williams just on a quick shot right down the seam.
Now, how about Roddy Williams? You see that, 250 pounds? When he was at Oklahoma State, his first 3 years, he was a quarterback. And now he's split up to the top. Williams in the slot. Mike Johnson barking the signals and giving it to Ricky Blake. And Blake on first down gets about five.
Now you saw Sean Woodson, number 59, make the tackle. That time he made the adjustment. Number 59 went out on Ronnie Williams. And then when he saw the run, he came in for the good tackle.
And right away, the Riders, they're going with a strict no-huddle offense, which is something the World League has encouraged. And Ronnie Williams, even though he's listed as a tight end, is really lining up in slot positions as a wideout. Almost 4 minutes in, no score, and the Riders driving.
Something you take for granted is the quarterback exchange, but Mike Johnson doing a good job getting back on. Now, if you just heard him at the end of that, he called last time very quietly. He was calling to his offensive lineman for the blocking assignments. Now, here it is. He just doesn't get a hold of it, but smartly gets on top.
621 run! 621 run!
Mike Johnson has strong vocal cords. Third down and six. Rolling right, throwing back up for Garrett. Just off his fingertips at the 10-yard line. Ryan McFetter got up there for Raleigh-Durham. That ball did not miss by much.
Well, I tell you, it was a misplay by the defensive backfield. You see number 23 right there, Brian McFetter, as he lets Garrett get by him, but the ball just overthrown.
Maybe if the ball was thrown correctly, McFetter would have got his hands on it so they don't get hurt. Now, you see San Antonio in punt formation will not kick the field goal.
And it's Kent Sullivan to punt. Marvin Hargrove, the only deep back for the Skyhawks, but this one is angling, and Sullivan got it out. And they're going to mark it at the 3-yard line. Marvelous punt by Kent Sullivan to back up the Skyhawks on their first possession.
Because if you don't watch your figure, who will?
It's the right beer now.
Because when it comes to water, the only place to start is at the top.
It's the right beer now.
Because when the party's going full steam, you don't want to fill up. So reach for the beer that won't slow you down. The Silver Bullet.
Cool, it's right, it's the right beer now.
I am a car maker. Making cars friendlier to the environment is something I think about a lot.
One answer is more fuel-efficient cars.
We're also working on alternative fuels, like our Impact, designed to be the first really practical electric car with enough zip for the California freeways.
25 GM cars today put out the same amount of tailpipe emissions as one car from 1970. Now that's progress.
This shows where we were throughout the whole thing. You know, looking at that now, I realize how close it was. And this is what's left of our garage. We didn't have much left in there at all. And this is what's left of our camping trailer that ended up in our neighbor's tree. They were here right away to help us out, and that's
obviously
all true.
Look around.
It's only been a few days, and they're already here rebuilding our house.
I'll see. Still, even though it's been 3.5 weeks later, they're still calling to find out how we're doing.
Welcome back to Raleigh, North Carolina. Raleigh-Durham will take over, pinned back at their 3-yard line. A 32-yard punt by Kent Sullivan of San Antonio, but he killed it at the 3. And Bobby McAllister brings the Skyhawks to the line with one back, Sean Doctor, who goes out. And McAllister unloads it just as he's nailed. And now a flag is thrown down the field.
I think we got defensive holding on number 25, Calvin Nicholson, who was in the game starting in place of Sean Dykes. He got caught, but that's a smart play. If you're going to get beat, you might as well grab the guy, because if you don't grab him, it's probably a touchdown.
Illegal contact, number 25 defense, first down.
That
That's a 5-yard penalty, but automatic first down.
Nice call, Professor.
Well, that's a tough position to play. You're a cornerback, you're out there by yourself. You don't always have help from the safety, and if you're one-on-one, if the guy beats you, you can't turn around and shout.
So the pass was intended for Clarkston Hines. Instead, it's first and 10 now for the Skyhawks from their 8-yard line. And they run the ball, and that is Joe Merton, the tight end, coming out of a tight end position from Oregon, carries the ball. He is a blocking tight end, does not catch very many passes, as you see the skilled position people. Hargrove is a good wide receiver who doubles up as well as a defensive back.
Only two healthy wide receivers.
And the offensive line for the Skyhawks, he looks a good size. Kelly John Lewis, 320 pounds.
Two tight ends now on second down. And a blitz, and McAllister gets rid of it.
Now that should be intentional grounding, which should be a safety.
That's
because
right.
It's in the end zone. That is, in a sense, a good play by McAllister, just trying to get the ball away. But he had no chance for a completion, no realistic chance. That should have been intentional grounding.
David Bailey put the pressure on, and this is exactly what Roman Gabriel talked about before the game. He said it takes 2 years for good offensive lines to pick up the stunts and things the defense will do.
Now here he is. He's just trying to get rid of the ball to avoid the sack with no realistic chance for completion. That's what the rule states.
Third down and 10 now from the 8-yard line, and they run it again with Sean Doctor into the middle. He gets about 4, but he'll be 6 shy as Donnie Gardner and Grant Gilbert for San Antonio.
Line of attack. Watching Raleigh-Durham open up, they've come out with two tight ends as a reaction to their two wide receivers being hurt, leaving only two wide receivers. So they come out with the two tight ends trying to control the ball, but now they've got to punt the ball.
The Skyhawks have had a bad punt game. Their net punting average just 28 yards. Fonts averaging 37, but good returns. Here comes the rush, and they block the punt, and it is out of the back of the end zone for a safety.
Gary Richard, number 44, came in untouched from the right side. 10-man front that time, just came in untouched, and he did a great job. We should be able to see this just laying out. Look on the right side of your screen, he's number 44, and watch him lay out for the ball. He's coming in right, well, you can't, there he is. He lays out for it, takes it right off the punter's foot. Now, fortunately for Raleigh-Durham, it goes out of the end zone. San Antonio can't get on it for the touchdown.
Kennedy Wilson just missed the 6.
Now, again, the block point is way out here. Now, look at the reach for it. See, he's not going to hit the punter. He's going to get the ball and get nothing at all. So that's a great job by Gary Richard, number 44, cornerback. Now, the bad news about a safety, you give up 2 points, then you also have to give the ball up with a punt.
But David also outlines, again, we mentioned Raleigh-Durham's had a bad time with their punting game this year. Special teams in this World League have been exceedingly difficult. No one seems to be really excelling on it.
You know, here's a tough thing for the punter, and they're talking to him right now, is when you see that 10-man front, you have to hurry it up just a little bit to get it off. But at the same time, if you hurry it, you're probably not going to have a good punt. So the punter's saying, well, I want to have a good punt. And the coach is saying, well, you got to hurry it up. So now Raleigh-Durham is going to be faced having to punt the ball, giving up probably good field position.
And Fonts kicking it high and short. Lee Morris from the 30-yard line. And he got to the 40, but there's the point. San Antonio gets 2 points and the ball at their 40.
And let's give those 2 points to Kent Sullivan, who is the punter for San Antonio. If you recall, he put it out on the 3-yard line. I'm going to punt up.
Did you ever punt your life?
I'm going to pump up these punters right now. But Sullivan, he put it out inside the 10 and caused Raleigh-Durham to have to punt out of their own end zone.
I'm running.
Well, the Riders huddle up here on the first down. They didn't huddle very often their first drive when they went 42 yards.
Staying with the two back.
Johnson drills it, and a late flag is thrown as Dwight Pickens goes out of bounds in Raleigh-Durham territory, but a very late flag.
I think we may have the center downfield. It looked as though John Vitale, number 67, was a few yards downfield.
Offensive pass interference, number 71 offense. That's the carries, lock it down and 10 yards.
Now, I want you to explain to me how the offensive left tackle, Mike Kislak, can commit pass interference.
Well, that's when you're downfield. That's what they call it.
But he hit someone.
No, he just went downfield. That's what they call it.
Okay, keep an eye on number 71. He's the left guard. Now watch him go downfield. He cannot go downfield. I also saw the center left side of your screen. Now he's going to leave the screen, but down here, see a couple offensive linemen downfield. That's what they call it.
So it's 10 yards and a loss of down. And it's second and 20 from the 30. Oh, Johnson had a man wide open. Ronnie Williams, the tight end, was in the seam, and the ball was tipped behind him.
You know, here's the thing. We come in and we say, what is San Antonio going to do? They're going to run the ball. So what do they do on both drives on first downs? They pass the ball. The first time they pass it, they get sacked. Second time they pass, a 10-yard penalty. Third and 20.
And the 35-second clock really speeds up this World League game. We're already down to just 8 seconds on the play clock. Six defensive backs in for Raleigh-Durham. That's it. That one is caught by Garrett. Now, did he go over the line?
I don't think it was caught.
No, caught.
It appears as though Brian McFadder dove in front of him and actually tipped the ball. But I'll tell you something, you hear the crowd right now, Raleigh-Durham appreciative of this good defense early on.
Well, it looked like Mike Johnson had crossed the line of scrimmage. Came very, very close, but got away with an incompletion. That will bring Sullivan back out to punt.
Leading scorer, Sullivan, 2 points.
Hargrove, Marvin Hargrove, deep for Raleigh-Durham. And he calls for a fair catch.
Now, did you see what Sullivan did that time? Saw the pressure, so he rushed it. Not a great punt, but he got it across the line of scrimmage.
2-0 San Antonio.
Got him. Got him. Need him? I got six double running backs.
You want me to trade the Raiders linebackers? No problem.
Collect Pro Set football cards with your favorite stars in action and get a Pro Set World League card in every pack, plus a chance to win free official NFL memorabilia.
That first kid, you think you'll trade Warren Moon?
Only from Pro Set, America's number one football card.
Norrell offers you the ultimate spring cleaning. You work hard to keep a clean home, but what about the dirt you can't reach? Your air ducts are full of dust and dirt that can litter your home whenever the heating or cooling system comes on. It's not just dirty, it's unhealthy. Norrell's Power Vacuum Duct Cleaning leaves you a cleaner and healthier home. Take advantage of our ultimate spring cleaning today and receive a free house cleaning from Mini-Maid. Now, that's comfort with a personal touch.
You can depend on Norrell.
Tantino, bring the car around. I want to go to a pasta shopper for lunch. You know, the new Italian restaurant in Fultondale at a Winn-Dixie Shopping Center. They got a fettuccine alfredo, lasagna, chicken cacciatore, and real Italian sausage, and a stromboli sticker sandwich. They got a lunch special every day. Today, it's a spaghetti and meat sauce, just a $3.95. But don't tell Mama. She'll be mad. A pasta shop, they cook up better than Mama.
Sure. The greatest legends of golf go head-to-head in the 1991 PGA Seniors Championship on USA. Thursday and Friday at 4, live Eastern.
A safety with has San Antonio in front. Just past the midway mark of the first quarter. We'll look at the defensive line for San Antonio. Donnie Gardner from Kentucky made terrific strides the first couple of weeks. And those outside linebackers for the Riders are strong.
They can put pressure. That's why we've seen the two tight ends here early on by Raleigh-Durham. We see it again.
Cooks and Manning both put terrific pressure on opposing quarterbacks as McAllister hands it at Sean Doctor, who has been more of a pass catcher than a ball carrier thus far in the season. Four carries and David Bailey makes the tackle.
Bailey doing a nice job coming down from the outside to get Doctor from behind. He shouldn't make that play. We talked about Sean Doctor early on. We'll see him all over the place. But again, Raleigh-Durham coming out with the two tight ends, trying to give the quarterback a little more help, better blocking for the running game.
You see just 42 yards. Raleigh-Durham's leading ball carrier, 61 yards for Darryl McGill. That's the total of three games. Here's the pressure and a screen set up to Doctor, and San Antonio snuffs that out. Terrence Cooks, number 50, was the first man, and Doctor is down.
Boy, that would be
need
a
one.
Big blow for be a big blow for this Raleigh-Durham offense. Roman Gabriel, he's been faced with problems this year, both at the wide receiver spot and now that Sean Doctor is down. How about Donnie Gardner, the left defensive end, with the pressure that time?
What's tough about this, Doctor, an obvious pain. Our first game, Dave, we talked about how in this World League with 40 players, 36 of whom are real football players, four Operation Discoveries, you have guys playing both ways. And Raleigh-Durham is already using some of their wide receivers as nickelbacks. We'll return to Raleigh, North Carolina in a moment.
Here's something for all you truck drivers to think about. There's an oil made special for trucks. An oil with the Shell brand. Oil that protects engines when they rev their highest and work their hardest. Think any oil will take care of your truck? Think again. Truck Guard. From Shell. Because if you don't watch your figure, who will?
It's the right beer now.
Because when it comes to water, the only place to start is at the top.
It's the right beer now.
Because when the party's going full steam, you don't want to fill up. So reach for the beer that won't slow you down. The Silver Bullet.
Cool, right, it's the right beer now.
Let's take off our sneakers and get comfortable.
Uh-oh, sneaker odor.
Let's go to the movies.
Tame ferocious sneaker odor with Sneaker Tamers from Odor Eaters. Springy insoles with activated charcoal, the world's most powerful odor destroyer. Sneaker Tamers has it, Scholl's doesn't. Sneaker Tamers absorb sweat, destroy sneaker odor, guaranteed for the life of your sneakers.
No more sneaker odor.
Sneaker Tamers from Odor Eaters.
The Vice President's wife, the candidate for the White House, the network anchor woman. One of them is Hitler's daughter. Wednesday at 9.
Carolina, tough blow for the Skyhawks. Their top receiver, Sean Doctor, suffering an injury to his right leg. And now Darryl McGill, who was sent out to replace him, has come off the field as well.
Looking
at the right leg or knee of Sean Doctor, took a tough hit. We'll watch him catch this swing pass. Body wasn't meant to do things like that. Big rush on first down, and Bobby McAllister is sacked. On second down, I should say, a big rush. David Bailey and Terrence Cooks again. Say, this is the area we talked about, the blitz pickup. If you're a defensive team, just go after the quarterback until they show you they can pick it up. And so here's Troy Fonson to punt for the Skyhawks on 4th and 22. And the big rush again, and they just missed getting that one. Lee Morris takes a fair catch at the 34 of San Antonio. 4:36 to go in the first quarter here. The Riders lead 2-0. Let's get an update on the London-Birmingham game with Diana Nyad in New York.
Ted's first points are on the board down in Birmingham with this handoff from London's Stan Gelbaugh to David Smith, the former Hilltopper from Western Kentucky. Powers over the line, and London's up 7-0 in the first quarter. Let's go back to Ted Robinson.
That is not a good sight for Skyhawk fans to watch Sean Doctor in obvious pain on the sideline. Meanwhile, San Antonio takes over at their 35 first down. And the give is to Blake. And Ricky Blake tries the right side, and there's a better first down defensive effort for Raleigh-Durham. Rafe Wilkinson, inside linebacker, gets through and makes the initial hit. You know, the one thing about this, Raleigh-Durham is taking a lot of hits out here. They're only down 2-0. The Riders have had great field position in their first three drives. Second and 8 here. Hundred Johnson going in motion up the top, and Blake the handoff. So once again, Under Johnson went in motion. He was not picked up by anybody on the Raleigh-Durham defense. I'm sure he'll come back to Mike Johnson and say, look, they didn't cover me that time. One of the linebackers was pointing. Somebody's got to get him, but nobody went out with Johnson, number 27. Under Johnson, the backup to Ricky Blake. In the game now, the Riders going to a lot of two-back formations. again, this time with a lot of room. And the tackling for the Skyhawks continues to struggle, and a great effort by Blake takes him to the 33 in Raleigh-Durham.
You talked about it, Teddy. He got hit initially at the line of scrimmage by one of the defensive linemen, but just kept his balance. And the nice thing about a running back, they're taught to put their hands down. You'll see the initial hit right there, but he gets through. Now he's going to get hit again. And why did you put the hand down and maintain the motion? Another missed tackle. Put the hand down. Get that extra 10, 15 yards. The missed tackles have hurt Raleigh-Durham, but again, they're only down 2-0.
That was an extra 15 yards for Ricky Blake with that ability to maintain his balance in midfield. Now, Larry Nemer's asking for the play clock to be reset. In the World League, as soon as a play ends, the play clock resets at 35 seconds. Makes it very tough for teams, especially after long pass plays, to get themselves squared away again. Four wide receivers. And down the far side, and out of bounds. Independent receiver Dwight Pickens.
Good coverage that time by number 26, Pat McGurk. That pass could not have been caught. McGurk just with a good single coverage. And on that play, both the tight end and the fullback were split out. Under Johnson again split out. Now he's coming to the backfield. But a good play that time. You look at number 26. He's a right defensive end, Pat McGurk. Now they're talking to one doctor talking to another right there.
Second and 10. And it's Blake. And there's a good stick.
Troy Stedman with a good shot inside.
And correction, it's Undra Johnson with his first carry. Out of West Virginia, he played on the Mountaineer team that played for the national championship in 1988. There goes Troy Stedman.
So one thing you're seeing now is Raleigh-Durham is making a change on defense, even though San Antonio going with the no huddle, so you can do it. Now a guy running on late. They got 12 guys on the field. 11.
On third down, and they get it to the lone setback with four wide receivers. The handoff goes to Broderick Graves, and 75, John Carter with 94, Anthony Butts.
Looked like they had 12 guys. Anthony Butts, number 94, comes in on third down play, and he just stands at nose tackle, stands up his man and comes over, gets some help from number 75, John Carter. And so far, Raleigh-Durham doing a good job defensively.
They've done is they stand up their 30-yard line. They haven't let San Antonio get inside it. Sullivan angling again. And he got it again inside the five. This one out of bounds at the two. Great punting in the first period by the Riders, Kent Sullivan.
In trying to make an artistic statement, one should be careful not to let one's personal aroma do the talking. In order not to offend the critics, I recommend Right Guard Sport Stick. It provides maximum protection and the freshest scents, a sublime palette of odoriferous emanation. After all, a true artiste should be remembered for his inspiration, not his perspiration. Right Guard Sport Stick. Anything less would be uncivilized.
Most guys would tell you they don't really think about their hair. Right. Personally, I think most guys want their hair to look good, as long as it's not a hassle. That's where Pert Plus comes in. It's a unique shampoo and conditioner in one. So, you get clean, more manageable hair than with plain shampoo, but without any extra work. That's Pert Plus.
Hey, I admit it. I think about my hair.
But it's not all I think about.
Wash and go with Pert Plus. Also in dandruff control.
Who's got the marketing plan?
I do.
Sales forecast.
Right here.
Presentation board?
Murphy's got
one. Where's Murphy?
This is the final boarding call for Delta Flight.
Maddie Klein knows careers are riding on Delta Flight.
Mr. Murphy?
Yes.
Better go.
Nobody told me how to cast.
Nobody knows.
Maybe that's why more business people fly Delta than ever before.
Mr. Murphy, you have a nice trip.
Thanks. Already had one.
Sean Dykes of San Antonio, who got down there to kill this punt at the 2-yard line.
Now Let's see what he does. He runs into the end zone. Does he get back out into the field of play? Watch him, number 22. Now, here he's in the end zone. He's got to get back in the field of play before he touches the ball. He was still in the end zone, folks. And there's a loose football in the end zone. And San Antonio's David Bailey recovers it for a Riders touchdown. The first carry, attempted carry by Brent Lowry of the Skyhawks, and he fumbled the handoff. And let's give another 6 points to the punter, Ken Sullivan. Oh, boy. You know,
you're saying that's a play that should have come out to the 20.
That is correct. Now watch the inside backers and watch everybody. Pressure inside. They never had a chance. But the loose ball, Bailey jumps on it, touchdown.
So San Antonio with 2 points from special teams and now seven by the defense as Bailey attempted seven as Bailey falls on the fumble. Now Jim Gallery from the University of Minnesota, just his second week as San Antonio's kicker. This is one area where San Antonio has had problems in the field goal kicking game. They're only 2 for 8 this year on field goals. The Gallery drills the point after through. 57 seconds remain in the first quarter. And San Antonio now leading Raleigh-Durham 9-0. I can hear the defense for San Antonio next time the offense runs on the field. Just hold them offense until we get the ball and score. David Bailey out of Oklahoma State played for the Philadelphia Eagles as a free agent at training camp this past year. And David Bailey scores the touchdown for the Riders. Raleigh-Durham got hurt here last week, David, against Barcelona with bad first quarter field position. The same thing has happened to them tonight. Field position, points scored, yards allowed. Field position is so important. That's why special teams are important. And we talked about this league. They've kind of taken a back seat early on because of the timing factor. You just don't have a lot of time. Now, from a positive standpoint, San Antonio doing a good job punting the ball downfield, pinning Raleigh-Durham in deep. When you pin a team inside their own 5-yard line, you eliminate 50% of the team's offense. Eliminate it, and as a defensive team, you know that, so you know what to look for, and it helps you defensively. Gallery will kick it. Raleigh-Durham with Marvin Hargrove and Pettis Samuel as the deep back. This will be Hargrove, former NFL kick returner with Philadelphia. Marvin Hargrove, and he's out across the 20. You know, Tyrick Manning with the tackle. The one thing we haven't talked about, some of the rule differences on kickoffs. If you don't bring it out of the end zone, it comes to the 10-yard line. So we haven't really seen that come into play yet, but it could happen at some point in time. Now, Raleigh-Durham back on the ball. Let's see if they can get something going here. Amongst the rule changes that I love the most in this league, Dave, is even after an incomplete pass, the clock runs. It's almost running time. Look at that, 21 plays already. Double the plays for San Antonio. They have 9 points. It's been double the pleasure. And Brent Lowry hit for a loss. Not only has Raleigh-Durham had quarterback problems, but they've obviously had offensive line problems because they've had no running attack to speak of that this year.
Now we're seeing the two tight ends, Merton and Sprinkle, split out a little bit. That should loosen things up for the running game. They see the tight ends. They're both split out. They look like slot receivers.
Gallister out, and Joe Merton, tight end, cannot come up with it. And very quickly, Raleigh-Durham faces 3rd and 13. Now the diagnosis is not good. Sean Doctor with 2 torn ligaments in his right knee, and that likely will spell the end of this football season for him. Gallister along. Square out. Juggling drop by Clarkston Hines. With Calvin Nicholson on the coverage. Hines does a good job coming back to the ball, and he actually has it. Should have made the catch, but you know, even when things are going right, good protection, good pass, the receiver drops the ball.
Clarkston
Hines, a local favorite, played at Duke. Set some records there the last couple of years. The first quarter is over, and it has been all San Antonio. More on the defense than on the offense, but the Riders have the lead 9-0.
Ford, GM, and Honda won't have airbags in all their cars until 1994. By that time, approximately 60,000 airbags will have deployed in Chrysler-built vehicles.
From Gillette comes Sensor, the only razor that can sense and adjust to the individual needs of your face. Sensor blades are mounted on responsive springs to continuously sense and individually adjust to your face. The closest, safest, most comfortable Gillette Sensor, together with the richness of foamy shave cream for the best shave a man can get. Gillette, the best,
yeah. Every game I gotta wear all this stuff to protect my body. But I just slip into these to protect my feet. The pump from Reebok. Hey, I switched to the pump for support, protection, and a custom fit. Which means Boomer knows something that Bo don't know. Pump up and air out.
Switch to the greatest sports performance shoe in the world. The Reebok Pump. Pump up and air out.
Back in Raleigh, North Carolina with Dave Jennings, Ted Robinson. Story of this game to this point, Raleigh-Durham with 11 offensive plays in the first quarter, minus 17 yards. The Skyhawks offense has been completely stymied by a good San Antonio defense. Troy Fountain into punt again, a 10-man front for the Riders. And Fountain gets that one away. Lee Morris, whoa, right after the loose football. I think you have to say Dave made a mistake.
Just saying, you got to put up the hand and you got to wait for that fair catch, because when the guy's coming down on you like that, there you don't have an opportunity to put it away. And that's a great timing play by number 23, Brian McFadder. 37 yards on the punt, and that time Raleigh-Durham did a good job in blocking Gary Richard. Didn't get close that time. He got down, and we're seeing a lot of mistakes here tonight, which are leading to big plays. Now it's up to Raleigh-Durham to capitalize. Now here it is again. He's got to put the hand up.
That's Brian McFadder that hit him. Lee Morris knocked the ball loose. First down, Raleigh-Durham, San Antonio 39. And I believe the play clock ran out on the Skyhawks. Well, let's see which way they go.
Number 58, Roderick Manning, came across very quickly, but there's no time left on the clock, and the penalty's in the backfield.
Number 11, offense, still first down.
You know, Raleigh-Durham had the same problem last week getting plays in.
That's right.
Had to call a couple of timeouts early in the first half.
And we should also mention that the mistake Morris makes here, Dave, is that with a 10-man rush, he has no blocking back.
That's correct.
First and 15, McAllister scrambling. This is what he excelled at Michigan State when he quarterbacked the Spartans through a Rose Bowl win. He got back to 5 yards, plus about one or two more before David Bailey ran it down.
Now he gets out of the pocket a little early here because he's been hearing those feet all night, but he makes a big play, although he only gets 2 yards on it, or actually 7 yards, makes a big play out of nothing.
McAllister ran one in against Barcelona last week. Second down. Tipped at the line, short of Merton, and then David Bailey, who's playing a great first half, got that one.
Gets the touchdown a few minutes ago, and now gets the hand on the ball.
It's interesting, Dave, to look at a Bobby McAllister who has the label running quarterback from what he did in college, but he, like Tony Rice in Barcelona, they want to come into this league and dispel that thing. The yardage difference tells the story. Four wide receivers for the Skyhawks on third and 8. Oh, that one came close to being picked off, and it was Gary Richard defending Marvin Hargrove, and on the incompletion, the Skyhawks pull out the punt. Richard's been around tonight also. Blocked punt on that coverage there. And now we'll see if Troy Fons can do the same thing that Ken Sullivan has been doing at the same side of the field. So the Skyhawks are not able to take advantage of the turnover. They punt for the fourth time. That's a good-looking high punt by Fouts. And, oh, it took a bad hop on the Skyhawks. Goes over the line they had set up at the goal line. So that goes into the end zone and will come out to the 20-yard line. for San Antonio with 13-14 remaining in the first half, and the Riders leading 9-0. Mike Johnson with a wireless mic comes to the huddle.
Hey, numbers one, okay? So, numbers one. Wide right over, 38 toss, on one. Hit.
38 toss, it's going to be a toss to the right side on the first snap count, unless he audibles.
Running by Broderick Graves. Ronnie Williams throws the big lead block. Broderick Graves is a hometown boy. He's from Charlotte. He went to college at Winston-Salem, just west of Raleigh.
There's that first down efficiency I talked about earlier. I've talked about in previous games. A 9-yard gain on first down just sets up everything else for you. This is almost a throwaway down here.
Again, four wide out. Johnson's going to keep it.
Busted play. He's trying to hand the ball off inside, but Graves did not take it from him. So the smart thing, you just tuck it away and take it upfield. If you're going to get hit, just don't go backwards. Graves gets the Johnson gets the first down.
I wonder if that's Mike Johnson's college sweatbands. He has the sweatbands with the Z on him for the Akron Zips.
I haven't heard from Bill Hess. He is the left slot receiver number 83. He's their leading receiver.
Big hole up the middle. And San Antonio continues to hammer away on the ground as Broderick Graves gets it across midfield. Huge hole by that middle of the San Antonio offensive line.
Well, something we talked about earlier, they do run the ball well. We didn't see it early, but we're seeing it now. If you can run the football, it's, you know, fans maybe don't like it a whole lot, but it's how you win football games.
Davis, this World League season, inaugural season goes on, it seems like we're seeing more and more teams trying to simplify their offenses. Quarterbacks have been hurt. Out to Ronnie Williams on the pass, and he's down there with 40 of Raleigh-Durham. Roy Stedman, good tackle for the Skyhawks, but it seems if the offensive lines can't handle the stunts and the blitzes, coaches are saying, okay, we're going to get simple and run the ball.
Well, you don't have a lot of time, so you got to keep it basic and simple, and that's why sometimes these fancy things on defense work, because you haven't had time to pick those things up.
Second down and a yard. We have 11:15 to play in the first half. San Antonio driving, and they lead the game 9-0. And now they're using Broderick Graves, who's listed as their third-team running back. He's playing like a first-teamer on this drive, 29 yards on three carries.
James Harper, who is the right guard, just pulled into the hole and led up for a nice block for Graves. Got to plug those offensive linemen also. Graves getting the work here, three rushes, 30 yards. Not a bad average.
He was a draft pick, New Orleans, ninth-round draft pick of the 1990 draft. Three wideouts on first down. And wide open down the far side, and in is your man, Bill Hess, for the San Antonio touchdown.
Richard Smith, number 41, blown assignment. He was over there, but just let Hess go. We talked about him just a few minutes ago. Leading receiver is Bill Hess, lined up on the left side. Top of your there he is in the slot. Now he just runs by. Now there's just a blown assignment, because there you can see number 41 is Richard Smith. He thinks he's got help deep, but he doesn't. Coming in late, maybe number 29, Gerald Mack. So one of those two guys.
In gallery for the extra point, John Garrett, wide receiver, does the holding. That was a blistering 80-yard drive by the Riders. Garrett did a nice job to put that ball down. Gallery drives it through, and so we have 10:33 remaining in the first half, and it's a quiet Carter-Finley Stadium in Raleigh. The Riders out 16-0.
A company can learn a lot in 125 years. As you learn, you make your product better and better. 125 years of quality. That's why people who know use Valvoline.
In making an artistic statement, one's personal aroma shouldn't do the talking. So I use Right Guard Sports Stick with maximum protection. A true artiste should be known for inspiration, not perspiration. Right Guard Sports Stick. Anything less would be uncivilized.
This is where it happened. The breakthrough in urethane chemistry that created a car polish so technologically advanced, one application lasts an entire year. Introducing Finish 2001, the car polish you use only once every 12 months. This old car's been badly neglected. Its finish appears destroyed. With no rubbing, no buffing, Finish 2001 with its urethane formula safely brings back the showroom shine, a rich, deep gloss shine that lasts an entire year. We tested Finish 2001 against other leading polishes, even some that claim to protect your car against fire or against acid. And the test results? Nothing, but nothing protects or shines better than Finish 2001, the 12-month car polish with a 100% money-back guarantee.
Finish 2001 is available at these fine stores.
Got him, come with me.
Bill Hess, a Division II All-American at Westchester in Pennsylvania. Again, lined up in the slot on the right side of your screen. A defensive breakdown, and Johnson just picks it up beautifully. Hess just takes it in. Again, you never know if it's a guy coming over late, in that case Gerald Mack, or was it the safety earlier?
It was a mistake is what it was.
That's it. One of the two guys. Five plays to go the 80 yards. 16-0, the Riders of San Antonio.
With an impressive first half. And Jim Gallery with a high and a short kick, and it'll be Marvin Hargrove at the 11-yard line. Hargrove out across the 25. He's a real interesting story. A guy who walked in to a tryout camp with the Philadelphia Eagles last year, went up to Buddy Ryan in the parking lot outside the Eagles complex and said, give me a chance. Ryan did, and Hargrove made their team and caught a touchdown pass last year from Randall Cunningham.
That's where Buddy's going to be somewhere this year. He's going to walk up to someone and say, give me a chance, right?
That's right. That's right. Hargrove had a good year returning punts until he had some fumble problems for Philadelphia. Well, the Riders with about 10 times the yards, twice the possession time, and a 16-point lead as McAllister airs it out. And his receiver, Hargrove, is claiming he got held up, but running into Anthony Cooney and Gary Richard down there, he ran out of places to go. Tough place to try and force a ball when your receiver is double-covered like that. And you're not going to get much help from the officials.
That's what most receivers do, though. They always look to the official. Come on, give me the call.
The Skyhawks at their 26-yard line. They have had one good chance after recovering the muff punt earlier in this quarter. McAllister again. That one is high and off the fingertips of Kevin Sprinkles. And I would say another thing, just watching the World League, Dave, that you notice quarterbacks are not quite as accurate. We get spoiled the incredible accuracy of National Football League quarterbacks.
Especially with some of these quarterbacks here. They've just been around for a little bit. They don't know the receivers well enough. And, of course, when you have pressure that McAllister's been getting, he's probably going to throw it a little bit more quickly than he would like to.
Now third and 10 for the Skyhawks. Pressured again. And that one is caught nicely. And that'll be a first down for Raleigh-Durham. Marvin Hargrove. And the fans getting into it. That is the first offensive first down for the Skyhawks in the game. They had one on the penalty on their first possession. And Marvin Hargrove, that's 12 catches now for Marvin this year. And with some injuries, Sean Docter being out, Clarence C.A., a good receiver they have, is out tonight. He's going to have to factor more in their offense. Ball carrier is Brent Lowry, and Tim Walton, 57 of the Riders, makes the tackle.
San Antonio, two very active inside linebackers, number 57, Tim Walton. Also Greg Gilbert, 55, good at rushing the quarterback, good at stopping the run.
8.5 to play first half, 16-0 San Antonio. Second and 8, McAllister, good job to get away from pressure. And he dumps it to Joe Meerton, the tight end, and he's in midfield. Greg Ross put the big pressure, but McAllister got away. At Legion Field in Birmingham tonight, the London Monarchs hoping to keep pace with Barcelona at 4-0, and they lead Birmingham in the second quarter.
European division, pretty tough division. are heading to Europe to play Frankfurt next Saturday. Find out how tough that travel is. McAllister heading for the marker, and he's run out just shy. And that's a good defensive recovery by Ken Watson to make sure McAllister didn't get the first down.
And McAllister has done an outstanding job on this drive, staying free. San Antonio rushing five and six guys, getting pressure. But McAllister doing a good job getting free. And
now the fans are letting Roman Gabriel know what they want to do. Go for it on fourth down and a yard.
Why not?
0-3, down 16-0. Now McAllister calls time as he comes to the line. Down to three on the play clock. 7.5 to go second quarter, and a big fourth down coming up for the Skyhawks.
Before leaving home, 50% of all travelers get butterflies. Two out of three leave someone they love behind. And nearly everyone thinks traveling is hard work. Nobody understands the trials and travails of travelers like Holiday Inn. And nobody gives them more comfort at a more comfortable price. Holiday Inn. Stay with someone you know who really knows you.
You'll find the most unique and affordable presents at Cherry's Interiors and Gifts. Choose from a wonderful array of traditional and Victorian accessories. You'll love Cherry's lamps, crystal, and decorator mirrors and pictures. Cherry's capable decorators can assist you in choosing floor covering, wallpaper, and fabric in all the latest styles and colors. So when you're looking for a special gift or accessory, come to Cherry's Interiors and Gifts on Grubbs Avenue off Fieldstown Road behind Gardendale First Baptist Church. That's Cherry's Interiors and Gifts.
$1 million is on the line in USA Network's World League Challenge, and you can win it instantly, along with a world of other big prizes. If you have the guts to play, remember, one play and life could be a whole new ball game. Catch World League football action on USA Network. Grab a game piece at participating KFC restaurants during April at these locations now.
To come back. He seduced and betrayed them. Now they're getting even. Jack Scalia, Katherine Oxenberg, Ring of Scorpio, April 24th and 25th at 9.
Dave Jennings, what do you think Coach Gabriel has decided here on fourth and one?
Well, seeing as the athlete that McAllister is, maybe move him. Put him outside on a little rollout. Give him the option to throw the ball or run it across. I don't think they'd get it up the middle. Too much pressure from the San Antonio defense. The inside backers are tough, but we're going to see.
It's still very early in this football game, but this is a key play. Raleigh-Durham needs something to give them hope. Fourth and one, and they jump. They got the first down again as Mearden got up in motion. And Mark Ledbetter, 94, jumped.
See, they reacted to Mearden.
Illegal procedure, number 72 offense.
Well, that I did not see. Kelly John Lewis moved.
And that changes the whole complexity of this play, so they're going to have to punt the ball. But Mearden went in motion. The defense jumped. Now, even though the defense jumps, you can't. The offensive linemen got to stay in their position.
That builder's contact.
Correct.
So the penalty takes the Skyhawks out of the fourth down try, and now their fifth punt. This time the Riders do not put the big rush on. And Lee Morris, after his muff, will take a fair head touch. So the Riders start from their 20-yard line, leading 16-0 after a 33-yard punt. And Richard Dean Anderson is a troubleshooter without a gun on MacGyver. See weeknights at 7, 6 Central on USA. Did you know Richard Dean Anderson not only is MacGyver, but he's an outstanding hockey player?
Without a gun.
Without a gun. London now leading 10-0. You saw the Monarchs and the Dragons, Dave. Compare the two.
Both European teams. Barcelona, strong team. They're playing very well, both offensively and defensively right now. Right now, they're the team to beat.
Ricky Blake back in the game. And the leading Riders runner is outside. And one saving hit by Brian McFadder. Or else Blake might have had a long one. You're getting great block. Ronnie Williams, that pseudo tight end, is doing a great job of blocking for San Antonio.
Leading around the left side,
And anytime you can get 9.5 yards on first down, just simply good blocking by the offensive line, and Blake comes up for the almost first down. Great blocking, though, offensive line. Second down at inches for the Riders. Johnson with a quick one. And that's Lee Morris, and he has a first down to the 35. You know, we talked about it last week, that Barcelona ran well against the Raleigh-Durham defense. The outside linebackers getting hooked just couldn't stop the run. And we're seeing it again tonight. At least after the first quarter got started, they went to the running game, and they're just piling up the yards. So a first down for the Riders at their 35. Mike Johnson, one score, confident in command. And that one just off the fingertips of the diving Morris at the Skyhawk 30 with Pat McGurk on the coverage. Picked up the safety blitz. Richard Smith, number 41, lined up on the right side and came in, but they picked it up. He'll be on the right side. You'll see 41 coming in with 59. There he is, but Johnson gets rid of the ball and just throws it up and almost. That's a great try right there by Morris. Tough catch.
As you can see what a difference another week has made for Mike Johnson.
Timing. It there. Mike Johnson had some communication problem, and the play clock running out will cost the Riders 5. Now you tell me, Dave, after watching the World League a little bit here, what's your opinion on the 35 seconds? Is it enough?
We see it speeds things up, and what they're trying to do is get more teams to go with a no huddle, so you eliminate that time needed to huddle up. But some teams still huddle up, and you also have to read at the line of scrimmage, and if the clock is running down and you're not getting the play in, as you saw right then, you're going to get the delay. Right, it's down to 10 seconds right now.
It is 25 after a penalty, correct, we should say. 35 after a play. Let's see how well Johnson can escape. And then got an interception. McGurk with the pick for Raleigh-Durham, and he's inside the San Antonio 35. A very poor decision that time by Johnson. Didn't get much on the ball. And you see right there, number 26 is Pat McGurk reading it the whole way. Just broke on the ball and cut in front for the interception. So the Skyhawks get another chance to get back in this game here before halftime. 5:12 remaining. Now you're going to see Johnson. He's not going to see anything here, so he's going to turn around, run back. And again, number 26 is the defensive back, McGurk, just reading it, breaks on the ball, and just cuts right in front. Lee Morris, the intended receiver, now on first down for the Skyhawks. McAllister, a tight end screen to Joe Mirton. And he's down near the 25. He had only caught one pass all year for the Skyhawks coming into this game. By necessity, Dave, he's going to be more involved in the offense.
Well, we talked about Sean Doctor, what he does, and he's out now for probably the year, and so other guys have to pick it up. Joe Mirton only caught one pass, a little misdirection that time, coming back to the tight end for a pickup of 7.
4:40 remaining first half. The Skyhawks trying to get on the board. No flags, even though there was movement up front. Down to the end zone, and just broken off, intended for Hines. Nicholson, who's been matched up with Clarkson Hines most of his first half, broke it up.
That's a great way to play defense right there. You trail the wide receiver, and when the ball comes, just reach in front with your left hand and bat it away. Just trailing him, that's a great job defensively. You really shouldn't throw the ball there with a defensive back that close. And that was Calvin Nicholson, number 25, third down and 2. Big play again for the Skyhawks. Blitz, so they pitch outside, and Lowry gets the first down. A good call by Raleigh-Durham.
Remember on that fourth down play, I said they would probably go outside against the San Antonio defense. You're not going to take it inside, so just turn and pitch it this way. You get the crackback blocking on the outside linebackers, and there's the whole outside run for the first down. And I'll tell you, 3:52 left. If Raleigh-Durham can get the 7 here, I think it'd be a big plus going in.
They have been thoroughly outplayed in the first half until this big turnover on the interception.
First down now at the San Antonio 22. Pressure! And McAllister got rid of it and should have had a completion. Kevin Sprinkles, a new addition to the team this week as a tight end, could not hang on.
Well, those inside backers come in, put a lot of pressure. Keeping in mind a rule change in this league, there is no in the grass. So while we saw McAllister was definitely in the grass, he don't blow the whistle until he is down. And Tim Walton that time, great pressure, but couldn't quite make the play. Credit McAllister with a heads-up play.
Second and 10 from the Riders, 22. Pressure this time, and McAllister cannot get rid of it, and it's Tim Walton again. The linebacker is very active for San Antonio. That time, Walton moved out on the outside. He's normally an inside backer. Moved on the defensive right side, came in untouched. You'll see him bottom part of your screen coming in, number 57. Here he is untouched, and blindside collision. Linebacker has to be the favorite position so far to play in this league. They've got three reads. Third and long yardage. Now McAllister trapped again and brought down at the 39. One thing a running back has to be able to do is block the linebackers. Number 30 is Brent Lowry, and he did not block Manning, who just jumped over him and coming from the blind side, hitting McAllister. McAllister is down. It was Manning, number 58, with a hit. He just leaped over number 30, Brent Lowry. There he is, number 58, Roderick Manning. Playing, he must have done the hurdles in college because he leaped over number 30, Brent Lowry, who went down, just probably closed his eyes. For a top part of your screen, you'll see the leap right underneath. How about that play? And blindside now. It's blindside because McAllister looking to his left. That's a great play right there by Manning. Next time, I'll bet you that Brent Lowry will not duck his head and go for the leg. Quarterbacking for the Skyhawks this year has bordered at times, I'm sure, on the masochistic. They've got to get some help. There goes Sean Doctor, their leading receiver coming into the game. He suffered a knee injury earlier, and McAllister shaken up. But that's a better sign. The backup now for Raleigh-Durham, a young man named Joe Pizzo, played at Mars Hill College and was running a cellular phone shop until a couple of weeks ago when the Skyhawks ran short on quarterback. Roy Fonts, the punt, sixth time in the first half. And that one goes off the side. It's a shank that will go out at the 20-yard line. It'll be the 18 when San Antonio will put it in play. 2:17 left in the first half. 16-0, the Riders.
Isn't Sir John late for tea?
Yes. I rather think he is. Rather. Jolly good cup of tea, Perkins.
Now no one is safe from American football. KFC introduces the World League Challenge Sweepstakes. You could win $1 million instantly or over 10 million other prizes, including delicious Kentucky Fried Chicken. So rush into your local KFC restaurant and play today. Good luck, huge!
No one can guarantee you a perfect world. A world where the unexpected never intrudes. Taken care of quickly and compassionately. In an imperfect world, you're in good hands with Allstate, a member of the Sears Financial Network.
Where the beat goes on, you don't want to fill up. So reach for the silver bullet, the one that won't slow you down.
We're talking about cool. Life is the ride for now. Take it out.
The Barcelona Dragons go head-to-head with the San Antonio Riders. World League Football on USA. Saturday at 8 Eastern.
Time now for the
for the Coors Light Silver Bullet, receiving leaders in the World League. Not surprising, Orlando up top, Byron Williams, 6 touchdown catches already.
And how about those night receivers coming in after the big win this weekend?
The run and shoot finally ran and shot. Bobby McAllister and Joe Pizzo starting to loosen up over there on the sideline for the Skyhawks. Moves down, and Blake gets the carry for the Riders, and he's across the 20. And that should take us to the 2-minute warning in a first half that has belonged pretty much to the Riders. San Antonio trying to even their mark at 2-2, leading 16-0. We'll have the final 2 minutes of the first half in just a moment.
Here, Joe. Careful, Mom, you can break real easy.
Hey, everybody. So what's the concern?
A whole meeting about springs and struts. Those details make a difference in a smooth ride.
Yep, it's a little wobbly up there.
The whole thing is wobbly.
Now, with these kind of meetings, we work better together, we build better cars. It's that simple. Everybody here is working together. Everybody has a responsibility for the final product. That's why our car has gotten so good.
My feet are so sweaty and smelly.
Here's why. Your feet have more sweat glands than any other part of your body. They need Super Drying Odor Eaters Foot Powder. Look, you'd need 25 cans of talc to match the drying strength of just one Odor Eaters powder. It can absorb 25 times more wetness.
Wow! It even keeps my feet dry. And no more smell.
Odor Eaters Foot Powder from the makers of Odor Eaters insoles with the world's most powerful odor destroyer.
Probably like to rewind the tape 4 weeks, go back about 4 weeks, we'll see if we can start this all over again.
Or else find his Los Angeles Ram offensive line. Where are those guys? And then Riley saying, hey, everything looking good, talking to Bill Hess.
Well, now that he can keep a quarterback healthy. 2 minutes to go in the half. Ricky Blake has already run for 78 yards in this first half of the Riders on 10 carries. And he gets an 11th and more good yardage. That's a first down for the Riders out to the nearly the 37. And now in the last 2 minutes of the first half, the clock will stop on first down. So they reset the ball. Johnson. And it's back out to Williams, and he's out of bounds. Across the 40, on the tackle for the Skyhawks.
One of the rare times tonight we've seen Raleigh-Durham make the first hit, make it a tackle.
A lot of missed tackles tonight, especially on a running game. Let's listen to Mike Johnson.
Wide left over. 580 switch. 580 switch.
Going for the band in the back of the end zone. That's good read. You got your man double covered. Just heave it up there. There's the band.
There, that'll be the halftime entertainment tonight for Raleigh.
This is the Cal band. Is it? Which is that band that came on the field?
Yeah, that was the Stanford band.
Yeah.
I believe that's South Carolina State. The yardage. The Riders pushing 200 yards here in the first half. Now Johnson on 3rd and 3, and we'll get a first down. A little quarterback draw and the hook fly. And with 1:22 to play in the half, the Riders are going to take a timeout as they have crossed midfield. And Mike Johnson, he was in Team Dallas 3 weeks ago.
go. Now he's quarterbacking the San Antonio Riders to a big lead.
They say you can see the future in the palm of your hand. Behold, JVC's smallest camcorder ever, with all the right features, from full-range autofocus to low-light sensitivity to tidal graphics. Plus, it easily plays in your VHS VCR. So at a mere 26 ounces, the future really is in the palm of your hand. JVC, we just made recorded history again.
Here's the Gillette sensor. It gives a nice close shave.
I can't believe I'm buying a razor for my son. He's really grown up. He's a grown man.
Soon he'll be packing up, moving out.
Come on, he's just a kid.
You know, since they redecorated, I almost hate to leave. Here it is. They've got Scott's liquid fertilizer and turf builder.
Oh, this is what I want. Listen, now that we got food for the lawn, how about feeding the lawn mower?
Coming up at halftime, the Reebok halftime report. We'll take a look at the London Monarchs, who are trying to stay unbeaten. If they do so in Birmingham tonight, they'll stay even with the Barcelona Dragons as the European division has dominated the World League.
Can you explain this to me there, Ted? Rock, chalk, sky hall.
That's a takeoff on the famous chant in Lawrence, Kansas. Rock, chalk, Jayhawks for the Kansas Jayhawks. So the Raleigh-Durham folks here at college basketball country, Dave, that's where we are. Trying to engender something new to push their team on. Ricky Blake, 90 yards rushing already in the first half as we have flags on the exchange. False start against,
it appears to be number 67.
Illegal procedure, number 71 offense.
Mike Kizilak.
Still first down.
Mike Kizilak, the left tackle.
Here we go. Just left, 832, all one. Rick.
Left, three wide receivers on the left side. I don't know what 832 is, but it's some passing play. There's the three wide receivers. One of them's a tight end. Here they come. Perhaps just off his fingertips. At the Raleigh-Durham 30, Ray Jackson on the coverage for the Skyhawks. We haven't seen as much of Ray Jackson, but he's their leading tackler, and really the guy Roman Gabriel says he's their best defensive back.
Well, he had very good coverage that time, and he was one who broke it up, so good play by Jackson.
The seventh round draft pick of Seattle, 1988. 1:15 to play in the half. The clock stops on the incomplete passes in the final 2 minutes of the half. Four receivers. Williams underneath, and Williams racing down near the first down stick at the 43-yard line of Raleigh-Durham.
Out of bounds at the 34-yard line.
Over. Wide right over! 388!
And Ricky Blake. It's a complicated game, Dave, so we try to make it complicated sometimes, but in a case like tonight, it's very simple. They pitch the ball to that guy, and the other team doesn't tackle him.
So if you can block and if you can run the footballs, we have a player down on the field. It's number 70 is Margate Miller. He just came in this week. He's a defensive lineman. He's down on the field. You can see him there, part of him.
Football is basic. If you can block, you can run. If you can tackle,
right now Raleigh-Durham having trouble tackling. San Antonio doing a great job blocking. Margate Miller now gets up. Mike Johnson on the sideline. Number 70. Comes down hard. That's a lot of weight there.
You know, Dave, we alluded to Team Dallas earlier. We should explain that for newcomers to the World League. There is a team that the World League funds in Dallas. Players train and live there during the World League season. And when Raleigh-Durham loses a player like a Miller, they go to Team Dallas to get a replacement.
Sean Doctor, they'll get another player for him. This could become the Raleigh-Durham-Dallas.
Wow, and that's already. Now, Margate Miller, who just left the game, was a Team Dallas import in the first 3 weeks of the season. Five already.
play of this San Antonio drive with a minute and five left in the half. Perhaps. And almost intercepted. Nice coverage by Sean Woodson back for the Skyhawks. Well, they had somebody with Hess that time.
And that time, good pickup of Ray Jackson, the safety coming in on the blitz. Just throwing it up. See, just be an athlete. Jump ball, go up and get it. Ball thrown inside, probably should have been thrown outside. Hess almost becoming the defensive back there. 58 seconds in the half, and it's second and 10 for the Riders. Skyhawks 38. Four wideouts to get.
Defender at the same time and made a marvelous grab for 34 yards.
And that time, I think it was Rafe Wilkinson, number 98, the linebacker way downfield on coverage. So a good matchup. There's Wilkinson. He was on Ronnie Williams. And you don't often see a linebacker going way downfield making the coverage. Now here, of course, Johnson rolling out to the side he can throw to. Watch Ronnie Williams. After he makes the grab, he's going to get up and signal for a timeout right away. Timeout. Didn't have to do it so fast, though, because inside the last 2 minutes, anytime there's a first down, the clock is stopped until they reset the stakes. But San Antonio does call a timeout with 48 seconds left, and they're ahead 16-0.
And on the door at the ball at the 4-yard line of the Skyhawks. Next week, the Riders expect to have their original quarterback this season, Jason Garrett, back in uniform. He suffered a separated shoulder in game one, but he began throwing this week. How much he'll play next week against Barcelona would depend in large part on how Mike Johnson's performing tonight. So far, his report card's going to look pretty good.
He's 7 for 15 for 108 yards right now.
Well, next Saturday, we'll be at Waldstadion in Frankfurt, Germany. Our first visit with USA, and these Raleigh-Durham Skyhawks will be in Frankfurt, and you'll see it at 2 Eastern, 11 Pacific Saturday. San Antonio home to Barcelona next Saturday night. You'll see that as well here on USA. Pressure. Johnson throws a bad decision and interception. And there's a worse decision that is covered by the Skyhawks at the 1-yard line. An awful
Rafe
decision
Wilkinson.
That time. Made the interception.
Awful decision and also a bad decision by Wilkinson to run it out of the end zone. I don't know what he's thinking.
Wow. Fortunately for the Skyhawks, number 73, Dave Amons, got on the ball.
But here's just he's just throwing it up for grab.
And what's Wilkinson thinking bringing it out?
No, he absolutely has to go right down with that.
He's just got to eat this ball, doesn't he, Dave?
Absolutely, because that now they've lost 7 points.
Or a possible
lost
3 points.
3 points, right.
At least Ray Jackson with the pressure on Mike Johnson. He threw it away. Wilkinson the interception, and then Ammons covered up the ball. So despite a huge offensive yardage advantage, the Riders have hurt themselves with a couple of turnovers. And Raleigh-Durham will try to run the clock out here as Darryl McGill gets the ball for the first time tonight. McGill back in the game after leaving earlier.
Now, Raleigh-Durham does not have to get a playoff because they are underneath the play clock by 1 second.
Play clock is at 18 right now, Dave said, so they don't have to snap this ball. Reebok halftime report coming up with the Riders firmly in command, but having lost the chance to pad the lead. I don't know why they're running a play. If you get a fumble here, it could kill you. And McGill holds on, runs the half out, but it was all San Antonio. Over 200 yards of offense for the Riders in the first half, and Roman Gabriel is going to have to regroup. The Reebok halftime report coming up.
Reebok pump, pump up, and they're out. Reporting from New York, here's Diana Nyan.
Welcome, everybody, to our halftime report here on USA.
I think to travel to a foreign country, you have to have something of a free spirit, but definitely to live abroad, you've got to be an adventurer. The London Monarchs, made up mainly of Americans, have adapted very well. They've got a perfect record on the field, and they're having a blast off the field.
To all the wives back in the States, women here are friendly.
I have some fish and chips, but they give you chips every day in the cafeteria. Every day, breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
London calling, I don't want to shout, but while we were talking, I saw you nothing else.
It's been really interesting. You know, we told our guys it would be a great life experience, and our rule number one is we're going to enjoy today, and rule number two is we need to win, and so far we've done both of those things.
The Monarchs are not just a team, they're a family. Tucked away in a small town north of London called Bushy, they live in dormitories on a school campus. And now that they're here, they have no choice but to amalgamate themselves into the British culture.
The chance to come over to England or, you know, Frankfurt, Germany or Barcelona, Spain was the reason that I wanted to do it. And to be over here is just a tremendous experience. You know, the people here have taken to us unbelievably well. You know, wherever we go, they look out for us. They invite us back time and time again. So it's been a great experience.
We've been made to feel right at home. You know, it's not like America, but then again, being in professional sports, you travel all around the world, so therefore you have to adapt. And I think we're adapting very well. We're 2-0, and I think it's paying off.
We're as big as any team in the NFL. And in the scrims, as we started developing an attitude, if we're not going to be pushed around, we're going to push around. And some people started calling us Nasty, and we kind of adopted the name. We called ourselves the Nasty Boys from that.
This is the Nasty Boys, Call of the Wild. Bear leads it. Go ahead, Bear.
Ready, boy? One, two, three.
Come on! Their camaraderie continues off the field at the Red Lion, a local pub in town that has become their home away from home.
You practice all day, you're banging heads, you're in a football mode. I think you need to come here, kick back, have a couple beers, and just slip away. You know, talk about something else. It really eases your mind.
But back on the field, it's all business. The business of entertaining the English fans and familiarizing them with a game that is somewhat foreign to them.
At first, they were a little bit standoff. They didn't really know how to play the game, but once everyone got into it, and I'm sure you saw the game as well, they were excellent, as good as any fans you could expect to have.
It's our second game and our second time. We'll be back for every game.
Everybody I've met that knows about the London Monarchs is just as excited as if we were, you know, an NFL team in that respective city.
If these boys can get us to the World Bowl, you'll see a whole new dimension to sports following for football here.
So far, this undefeated season has been a party for the Monarchs and for their fans who have been giving them the royal treatment. It looks like more than just a sports experience for the men on the London Monarchs team. Looks like a full life experience, and I'm envious. We're going to go back to Ted Robinson and Dave Jennings in Raleigh-Durham right after these messages. You're watching the World League on USA.
Where there is O, there are boys. Where there is O, there is love. And where there is O, a moment can be found. O is original. The Olympus IS-1. Hundreds of options in just one camera, allowing the photographer to capture perhaps the most important O of all. So, Olympus. Never miss another O.
Ford, GM, and Honda won't have airbags in all their cars until 1994. By that time, approximately 60,000 airbags will have deployed in Chrysler-built vehicles.
The World League of American Football is orchestrated by the beat of an international rhythm.
offensive Pfeffi gesprochen im Augenblick in der World League.
We don't return it for a touchdown. We put the
offensive on. You huddle up and we're going ninja to the wide field. Ninja to the wide field.
All right.
Ninja to the wide field.
Bell with a Statue of Liberty handle up to Mitchell. Mitchell fumbles. Now Mitchell's going to throw a pass. He's got a man wide open. He got a 10-5 touchdown.
The World League of American Football. It's out of this world.
Back in Raleigh, San Antonio leading Raleigh-Durham 16-0 at halftime. And welcome to our latest segment of Halftime Stadium Gourmet. Now, I couldn't get Jennings to touch the poutine in Montreal, but you're chowing down on a little good old pork barbecue.
It's for good stuff.
There, you like it?
No, good stuff.
Even without the sauce, right?
Good stuff.
So far, so. What do you think they're chowing down on right now in the San Antonio dressing room?
Not pork barbecue.
No,
for sure.
You never had that at halftime, did you?
I was here 2 years ago, and I had the same stuff. It's great, folks.
Is that right?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm looking forward to the schnitzel in Frankfurt this weekend myself. But while I take a bite, why don't you talk about the punting replays here?
The way this game started, at least the tone was set by the punting game, the special teams here. Great job on the right side. You can see Richard come through layout and just take it right off the punter's foot. This one out of the end zone for safety, but it just set the tone to nothing. Now, that was set up initially by a punt by number one, Ken Sullivan, who did a great job in the first quarter. Now, here he just releases the ball. Here's number one, Sullivan, and it's going to go downfield now. Dyke, here it is, aiming for the corner. Now, he doesn't get this one out of bounds like he did the first one, but here's Dyke, number 22. Keep an eye. He goes in the end zone. He's got to come back into the field of play before he touches the ball. I don't know if he did, but there's no replay in this league. So they put it on a one-yard line. And then a little later, we show Hess in the slot. Now he's going to run downfield. There's a defensive breakdown. You see number 41 leave him. He just lets him go because he thinks he has help. And then number 29 is going to come in just a moment later, but too much later. And Hess takes it in for the touchdown. Defensive breakdown.
You have revolutionized the analysis of highlights with Park Barbecue in one hand.
Oh, great job.
We'll have the second half for you from Raleigh in just a moment.
American Movie Classics, the newest addition to your basic cable lineup, is one cable channel dedicated to bringing you Hollywood's classic movies, uncut and commercial-free. And to stay on top of breaking news, world news, national news, sports, and entertainment news, tune into Headline News. Headline News, bringing you updated news stories in a concise half-hour format, is perfect for busy people like you. And now, during National Cable Month, Fincom is offering big savings on cable installation. Plus, be sure to ask about our money-back satisfaction guarantee. Call now and take advantage of these very special offers at 631-9555. That's 631-9555. Fincom Cable Television, your quality cable connection.
The World League on USA is brought to you by AT&T, the right choice, by the Coca-Cola Company and your local Coca-Cola bottler, and by Allstate, for home, auto, life, and business insurance. you're in good hands with Allstate.
Back in Raleigh with Dave Jennings, Ted Robinson, San Antonio leading 16-0, and it looks even more lopsided for the Riders when we look at the numbers.
You know, you look at that rushing yardage. We talked about it right at the top of the show. Could the Riders run? Could the Skyhawks stop the run? Right now, Ricky Blake, as of halftime, he's the second leading rusher in the league. You hear a few fireworks going off in the background. That is not coming from the Raleigh-Durham locker room.
Or did I miss the 4th of July? I'm sorry. That caught me by surprise there. Well, we've got a great weekend coming up for you next weekend. The World League on USA. Dave and I will be in Frankfurt, Germany. USA ventures to Walt Stadion for the first time. Raleigh-Durham at Frankfurt next Saturday night. The unbeaten Barcelona Dragons at San Antonio. And then next Monday, the Sacramento Surge at Giant Stadium to meet the New York, New Jersey Knights.
You know, I've been preparing for those European trips. I am studying a little German for this one. I had the last trip down perfect. I had that English down great. Yep, they understood me. It was real nice.
What did you have at halftime at Wembley Stadium?
And hot dogs. And hot dogs. It was unbelievable. I was expecting fish and chips. Yeah, and
you've let me down.
They're trying to Americanize it over there. They were booing the referees in London. I loved it. Hey, this is American. How much more American can you get?
Well, the amazing thing, the London fans know American football so well, they don't want to be treated as they are basically a foreigner.
The public address announcer made an announcement at the beginning of the game, we're going to give you the rules as the game goes along. He got booed also.
No whistles.
No whistles.
That's right. Jim Gallery approaching the ball for San Antonio. Raleigh-Durham in the red. Fumbling it. Finally, Pettis Samuel picking it up. And he is to the 20-yard line. So, Raleigh-Durham. And I give Bobby McAllister a lot of credit. He's still able to jog back out there after a first half where he saw nothing but white shirts in his face.
Well, on that last drive, especially linebackers coming in from his blind side on consecutive plays and just hitting him pretty good. But, you know, in this league, you've got to be ready to play because if you don't play here, you're not going to play. You don't go to a taxi squad, you got to play. And McAllister's back up, ready to go.
As a junior, he quarterbacked Michigan State to a Rose Bowl victory. He played half of 1 year for the Toronto Argonauts in the Canadian League. It's a pro experience. And Darryl McGill out of Wake Forest. Local reaction to that. Riding up across the 25, Greg Ross and Kennedy Wilson made the tackle for the Riders. McGill, seventh round pick of Washington in 1988, spent a year on injured reserve with the Redskins. Imagine a lot of folks here would like Mike Elkins, who's quarterbacking Sacramento, to be here. The local boys all from Wake Forest, and that's a first down carry for McGill.
They often talk about the first drive of the third quarter being important. I don't know as it is, but right here, two straight running plays. Two first downs, both around the left side, and the hometown fans like it.
And something that could take some pressure off McAllister would be any sort of a running game by the Skyhawks.
Nothing there. You know, the important thing for an outside linebacker, take a look at number 50, that is Terrence Cook, to be able to chase the guy down from the back side. There's number 50, Cook. Now, first two plays, they ran left. This time, they ran away from Cook, and he chased it down for the tackle.
Terrence Cook, out of Nichols State. He played for the New England Patriots 2 seasons ago, 1989. Ian Roderick Manning, great bookend pair of outside linebackers for the Riders.
Second down, there's a great fake by McAllister. Another first down for the Skyhawks across the 40.
You know, I don't think that was a design play because when McGill didn't get the ball, he looked back surprised as though something was wrong. Now take a look at McGill. He's the first guy through. Now he's going to turn. Wait, where's the ball? Here's McAllister coming around the outside.
He almost looked, Dave, as you see Richard make the play for the Riders, almost looked like he bluffed a fumble.
And that's sometimes the best way to run that play is don't tell anybody you're running it. That way, the fake for Eklund.
Quick drop, slant pass is caught. Marvin Hargrove at the 46 to San Antonio. And Raleigh-Durham is strung together three offensive first downs. That's the first time they've done that tonight. Hargrove, just a simple slant pattern and a beautiful pass by Bobby McAllister. High sunset, buddy. That's good. 3 minutes into the third quarter. Raleigh-Durham with a first down at the Riders 46. McGill on the delay. Darryl McGill. Inside the 15. Tell you what Raleigh-Durham did that time, a 20-yard run on the play. They put both their tight ends, Merritt and Sprinkles, and they split them out. That opens things inside. So he got the little delay action. Look at that hole. They spread open the odd defense. And now it's just a race to the end zone. Number 24 is Ken Watts in the cornerback. He stays in there to make the tackle, but it's inside the 15. Hey, has Raleigh-Durham been down here tonight? Just once, and they threw that interception in the end zone. 31-yard run by McGill. Now John Birch gets his first carry. John Birch from Tennessee Martin. He was an eighth-round draft pick of the Phoenix Cardinals in 1989. He's played some nickelback as well for the Skyhawks in the first half tonight. This is the first time of the game that Raleigh-Durham has moved the football into San Antonio territory. They've had it there twice on turnovers. Block opening up the hole. That's a great drive right there. That's a different team in the second half. Keep an eye on number 64. Terry Gray just kicks out, cooks the outside linebacker. There's the hole. And now Burch just takes it in for the touch. And certainly Dave running the football with difference to the Skyhawks. Wilson Hoyle gets a chance to kick the football for the first time since the opening kickoff. Skyhawks are on the board. They're excited here. An 80-yard drive. 16-7 San Antonio.
No one can guarantee you a perfect world. A world where the unexpected never intrudes. But some of us know we'll be taken care of. Quickly and compassionately. In an imperfect world, you're in good hands with Allstate, a member of the Sears Financial Network.
Interested?
No, no, no.
Lava, but don't try to cope without it, so.
Watch number 64, Terry Gray. He's going to take out Cooks. There's the block. A great block, and that opens things up. This is a different team we're watching here in the second half. 80 yards on just 8 plays, and again, the difference for Raleigh-Durham from the first half, they were able to gain something by running the ball. Kept some heat off McAllister. Wilson Hoyle to kick a 3-man deep for the Riders. And way up and racing up to the 10-yard line is Undra Johnson. Good coverage. And the Skyhawks get down there. And And it's John Birch who just scored the touchdown. Well, that's the World League, folks. Score a touchdown and then run down and be the kamikaze man on the coverage.
A lot of starters on special teams, almost like the Pro Bowl in the NFL when you see all the starters there. Roman Gabriel's got to be pleased. Look at his first half, total yards 20. In about less than 5 minutes, they get 80.
Yeah, say hello to my mom, my dad, my wife, the reader. Everybody back in the office.
Okay, John. Roman is saying, keep your mind in the game for a bit here.
The only guys he didn't say hi to were you and me.
You and me, man.
That's happened before, hasn't it?
3 yards on first down for Ricky Blake, who's creeping up on 100.
Like there's been a fly in the locker room at halftime. You just saw Roman Gabriel. He must have had quite a talk.
Now, David, you can't forget, not only the 80-yard drive, you see Blake there right on the doorstep of 100 yards. Not only that drive by Raleigh-Durham so impressive, but the critical interception that Mike Johnson threw in the end zone at the end of the first half. Blake, or that's under Johnson, getting to the 25, and that's it. So you were looking at a 23-0 game instead of 16-7.
Okay, if Raleigh-Durham can stop him here, you'll hear these fans erupt. Momentum is a big thing in pro football.
So right away, third down and almost five is what the Riders need, and they don't get it. The give to Blake and Zeke Gadsden. 52 out of Pittsburgh made the play.
Gadsden lining up right outside linebacker. Fights off the block by the running back. Keep an eye on him here. Fighting off the block and making the tackle to stop him just short of the first down.
And now this will be Kent Sullivan punting for the fourth time.
He's not used to punting back in his own territory.
Rolls it out where Hargrove takes a fair catch for the Skyhawks at the 37-yard line. And all of a sudden, Roman Gabriel, Skyhawks, making a game of it in the third quarter.
Why am I going to Opelika, Alabama?
It's Opelika.
Opelika, Opelika. Why?
And Mr. McKenna asked you to?
This is a good reason.
25% of business travelers travel to small towns. But in even the tiniest towns, there's a place with fax machines, meeting rooms that works. Holiday Inn. And that makes doing business 100% easier.
Nice town, Opelika. Opelika.
Holiday Inn. Stay with someone you know, really knows.
We're not horsing around with prices at Youngblood Mobile Home.
You can hook you up with this 1991 16x80 3-bedroom, 2-bath beauty for only $190 per month after down payment. To partner, come on out to Youngbloods in Adamsville, where we have a large selection of single and double wides available. Youngbloods is a name you can trust. We've been serving the Birmingham area for over 19 years.
Come to Youngbloods Mobile Homes and we will save you money.
Do you recognize this business? Quality professional builders do. They recognize Shaw Building Supply for their friendly, courteous service and low prices. This Black & Decker Professional 10-inch rotary table miter saw is on sale for $159. Check out this Black & Decker Professional dual-range variable speed cut saw with carrying case, only $126. Bring all your projects to Shaw Building Supply. Then you'll see why quality builders trade at Shaw Building Supply. Before you saw, check with Shaw in Mount Olive just off I-65.
The vice president's wife, the candidate for the White House, the network anchor woman. One of them is Hitler's daughter. Wednesday at 9.
Well, on the San Antonio sideline, starting defensive lineman Donnie Gardner got injured on the last play of the first half. We're told he may be able to return. John Fletcher is his replacement. But the guy up front that had a huge first half for San Antonio is David Bailey, 93. Be lining up on the right side now on this defensive front.
Last series for Raleigh-Durham, they opened up running left side successfully.
John Birch is the setback behind Bobby McAllister. Blitz. And the quick pitch. And a good charge by Ken Watson from the secondary to bring Burton down.
Ken Watson, the strong safety, playing up on that side. You see it a lot with these strong safeties. They play almost like a linebacker. The two inside backers, Gilbert and Walton, both came, and Watson was on the outside. Here he is. You might not be surprised to know he's the only Livingston product to ever be drafted by the National Football League. Minnesota free agent signee was Ken Watson. Here's McAllister on second down. And that one is short, incomplete. It's tipped into Hargrove at midfield. Again, two inside backers, Walton and Gilbert, coming in on the blitz, but picked up well, and McAllister standing in there, delivering the ball just a little short. He stood in there well, but the blitz forces him to have to throw it just a little bit early. So it'll be third down for the Skyhawks. They need 11 from their own 36. Looking deep. And it's a wounded duck up for grabs and intercepted. Greg Lee runs it back, and now, let's see, is that football loose? Yes, it is. And the Skyhawks get it back. And I'll tell you, the guy who's the unhappiest is number 93 in white, David Bailey. He came in, put pressure, and hit McAllister, forced it to go up like a wounded duck. But the interception, then the fumble, first down. Watch right side play of your screen, number 93 coming in. Here's Bailey. He's going to point. And there's the ball. Now, Lee going to return it. He gets hit here, loses it as he's going down. It appeared to be number 53 was Paul Wolf, the center, with the... And now here's a little flea flicker, and McAllister is hit from behind by David Bailey, who has been all over the Raleigh-Durham quarterback. This is a play that the Skyhawks have worked on. The flea flicker pitch back to the quarterback. Pressure from the outside. Bailey not going for it. Bailey, as you have said, we've called his name quite a few times. That's an 8-yard loss on first down. 4 sacks for San Antonio. Now McAllister tonight going to the gun. This time we've seen it. And a blitz by Cook and an incompletion. A good hit by Watson on Kevin Sprinkles, the tight end. Boy, and if I'm McAllister, look at him get up slowly. Number 50, Terrence Cook, untouched from the left side. That is a great shot on the quarterback, but he just popped right up.
Tonight, Mr. McAllister is learning that a dropback quarterback isn't always fun. You can see 24 yards through the air. And you're going to bet they'll be throwing this sink at him here again on third and 19. Gets it away. It's caught short of the first down. Clarkson Hines with the grab, but this is close enough that the Skyhawks can go for it.
They'll definitely go for it. And listen to the crowd. They're shouting for him to go for it. It'll be about a yard. Let's almost call it 2 full yards short.
So with 6:10 to play third quarter, San Antonio leading 16-7, but Raleigh-Durham with 4th and 2 upcoming from the 47 of San Antonio.
And the last time they had the situation, you got to call a timeout again. Last time they had an illegal false start against one of their linemen. This time they go to the timeout. Let's talk it over.
Well, the Skyhawks will come up, try to come up with a big 4th down play when we come back.
If you don't have AT&T 800 service and trouble hits, who knows how long you could be out? Only AT&T automatically protects you through the 800 assurance policy. With AT&T, you would be guaranteed back in touch in 30 minutes or less. With anyone else, who knows? But if you do have AT&T, your 800 service is guaranteed. That's not all. Since AT&T connects calls 25% faster and has the fewest block calls, more 800 calls get through, so you can make more sales. With all that, why choose any other 800 service? Better service, better results. Another AT&T advantage. Call now for free installation.
From the Far East to Europe. Across the Caribbean and throughout North America, only one airline covers so much of the world with so much warmth.
The greatest legends of golf go head-to-head in the 1991 PGA Seniors Championship on USA. Thursday and Friday at 4, live Eastern.
With Dave Jennings, Ted Robinson back in Raleigh. Dave, the timeouts that Raleigh-Durham forced to take on fourth down. Would a coach normally have certain plays he would just reserve for fourth down and short yardage?
Well, they have their short yardage and goal line package, although Raleigh-Durham hasn't been down there a whole lot this year, so they haven't run them a lot.
I'd like to see McAllister move it outside and become the athlete he is. Everybody up on the line, and Burch goes down and will be stopped short. Frank Gilbert, the first man to hit him for San Antonio, and the Riders take over. Burch lost his footing, and with that lost any chance to convert the fourth and two. And that takes a lot of the steam out of this crowd, which is expecting a comeback.
Just a simple handoff, and here he trips over his own feet, loses all his momentum. He does bounce up quickly, but by now, you don't have any chance to make the first down.
Well, Mike Johnson brings the Riders back up. Sends Undra Johnson out in motion, right? Ricky Blake, the setback. And Ricky Blake pushing across midfield, and that should push him over the 100-yard mark for this game. That gives Blake 105 yards now. The first San Antonio back to rush for 100. Averaging 7.5 yards a carry. Second and eight from a two-back set. And that's a tough one for Ronnie Williams. Goes through his fingertips. Probably would not have had 2 feet in anyway. In Legion Field in Birmingham tonight, London Monarchs still leading the Birmingham Fire 10-0.
You know, teams have had problems going over to Europe and playing, but coming over here, they're not having so many problems.
Take a look at Mike Riley. Now there's the walkie-talkie he is using to get the signal into his quarterback. Mike Johnson has a receiver in his helmet. And Johnson throws, and it's caught by Garrett. And John Garrett down inside the Raleigh-Durham 10-yard line. Brian McFetter saved the touchdown. He beat Gerald Mack that time, the cornerback. Just beat him cleanly, and Mack tried to make the play, but Garrett, who is the leading receiver on this team, you see it left side. Now watch Mack just dive. Can't quite get there. I'm sorry, Garrett, not the leading receiver. Bill Hess is, but just to beat the man one-on-one. John Garrett's brother, Jason, was the Riders' starting quarterback this year. Now it's first and goal, and Ricky Blake walks in for the touchdown. And this game takes another sudden reversal as the Riders strike quickly to go back in front 22-7. Okay, inside pressure that time by the linebackers. They all came inside, but there was a huge hole opened up by the two guards, number 77, James Harper, and number 71, Mike Kiselak. But pressure from the left side. See that the linebackers come inside, but a great hole opened up. Where are the inside backers? They came in for the pressure, and they were sealed off nicely by the guard. Gallery just slides the point through. And a 52-yard drive for San Antonio after the fourth down stop. And the Riders have opened up a 16-point lead.
Isn't Sir John Mace the team?
Yes. I rather think he is, rather. Jolly good cup of tea, Perkins.
Now no one is safe from American football. KFC introduces the World League Challenge Sweepstakes. You could win $1 million instantly or over 10 million other prizes, including delicious Kentucky Fried Chicken. So rush into your local KFC restaurant and play today. Good luck, kids!
Because if you don't watch your figure, who will?
It's the right beer now.
Because when it comes to water, the only place to start is at the top.
It's the right beer now.
Because when the party's going full steam, you don't want to fill up. So reach for the beer that won't slow you down. The Silver Bullet.
Cool, it's the right beer now.
Hey, that's not us. We're down here. We're down. So you haven't seen a lot of Daihatsu's here.
Not yet.
But as word spreads about Daihatsu quality, we'll grow bigger. And we won't get a stiff neck from looking up at the neighbors.
With our Charade three-door hatchback, Daihatsu quality starts from $63.97.
Look at the inside of the San Antonio line, Harper, Vitale, and Kizilak, and they just steal it off for the hole. The inside backers came through, but they were picked up nicely by that interior line. You know, we talked about it when I was last week in London. The Nasty Boys from London did a great job. The offensive line can block. That opens up the running game, and number 23, Ricky Blake, having a great night. Oh, very fast. Tim Gallery driving it deep for the Riders. Riders offside on the kickoff. This is Pettis Samuel, and he's out across the 25 for Skyhawks. Ricky Blake is up to 114 yards rushing now for the Riders.
We got a penalty. Offside on the kicking team.
And the Skyhawks now deciding whether or not they...
Penalty declined. First down.
First down to take the ball to the 28-yard line. Blake is 19 yards shy now of Paul Palmer, who has the early World League rushing record of 133.
Again.
Raleigh-Durham.
Raleigh-Durham last week.
First down for the Skyhawks, and McGill, well, he almost got stripped to the football. He wrestles forward, holding on to it to gain about two against the San Antonio defensive front. But with the exception of one drive, it's played very well tonight. And remember, San Antonio held Sacramento to just 36 yards of offense in the second half last Sunday to post their first World League win. Here's the pressure, and McAllister gets rid of it. Hit on the quarterback as well. Terrence Cook, number 50, lining up left outside, came through untouched, and they're going to give him the call now.
Push the foul. Number 50 defense with a blow to the head.
See, it's not a late call, and he's arguing because he says, I hit him okay, but the call was a blow to the head. They protect the quarterback. If the defensive player goes to the head, they're going to call it. If the defensive player puts his helmet down and drills him in the back. Left side of your screen, number 50 coming in untouched. Bang, see him go to the head, went to the head with the helmet. They don't allow that. Good call. So Hines with the catch, Cooks the penalty, and the ball's across midfield. See him go to the head, you don't do that. But Dave, this league will probably have to take some steps to protect quarterbacks at the rate they're getting hit.
Either league.
McAllister. Skyhawks are down to the 30-yard line. You know, once again, it looked as though San Antonio was getting great pressure, but for the first time. Now, watch all these guys come through. We've been watching it all night, but they're letting them through this time. So a great design screen. And you're looking at number 20, Daryl McGill taking it upfield. A well-designed play. So quickly, the Skyhawks move to the 30-yard line of San Antonio. We're under 3 minutes to play in the third quarter. San Antonio the lead, 23-7. Ran out of time.
25 yards. Harmon Gabriel.
Play a game. Number 11 offense. Still first down.
So emotional after Raleigh-Durham's touchdown drive. But that emotion sagging after the quick reversal and the Riders score. McGill inside. Gets only a yard. So you got to be impressed with the San Antonio defense. I'm impressed with Bobby McAllister, Dave, from the simple standpoint that he keeps picking himself up after a lot of hits.
Absolutely. How many times has he been on the ground tonight?
The passing numbers aren't great, but there'll be a courage factor in there that won't show up in those numbers. That's intercepted. Kennedy Wilson to the 40-yard line.
That's
a big mistake that gives San Antonio the ball back.
Kennedy Wilson that time taking advantage of the fact that number 50, Terrence Cooks, was in coverage. One way to keep him out of the quarterback's face, he goes into coverage, and he had the receiver deep. Now, on the left side of your screen, number 50, you can't see him right now, but he's in coverage, so Wilson settles in short. See him settling in short? There's 50, just came into your screen. Just a bad read by the quarterback, and Wilson understanding that he had help behind him. Terrence Cooks, number 50. Each quarterback has thrown two interceptions, and the Riders take over. And on the reverse is Broderick Graves, and he's near midfield. Now 2 minutes to play in the third quarter.
Well, Mike Johnson played in more of a sprint-out offense in his 2 years at Akron. Running four drop-back passing tonight than probably he did in his college days. He's got a great running attack to lean on, and here it goes again with Ungra Johnson crossing midfield. As always on USA, you can enter a mystical world where anything is possible on Swamp Thing, the series. Friday nights at 10:30, 9:30 Central on USA. Irwin Gabriel has probably developed a bit of a helpless feeling, Dave, when his defense is on the field. They haven't been able to get enough three and out as a team. Big hole for Graves, and he's inside the 40. Nice late block by number 27, Andre Johnson, leading up into the hole. And now we know why the Raleigh-Durham secondary is leading the team in tackle.
Right side of your screen, number 27, the late blocker. There he is. And he seals the hole, allowing Graves to run for some positive 9 yards on that play.
Johnson throwing. Williams catches. Ronnie Williams out of bounds at the Raleigh-Durham 33. That'll be a first down as Ray Jackson ran him out.
Tough play to cover when the receiver goes down 2 yards and just runs outside because you're running away from number 47, Ray Jackson, and a nice pass that time by Johnson for the completion and the first down.
This may be the last play of the third quarter. From the Raleigh-Durham 33, and it's Graves again. And a couple of hard-fought yards to the 30.
More missed tackles that time. Number 96, Troy Stedman, had the hit in the backfield as the third quarter winds down.
And the San Antonio Riders are in control again. They survived a Raleigh-Durham rush. They lead 23-7.
What's that crew going down? What's that Georgia crew? What's that eye that takes your breath away? That's the taste of real refreshment. That's the real diet coke. That's the taste of real refreshment.
Oil can protect your truck when it works its hardest, revs its highest. Think again. Truck Guard from Shell. Truck Guard presents the roughest, toughest, wildest, the greatest sports moments of the 80s. Yours free with any oil change or case purchase of Truck Guard. Or $2.99 with a one-quart purchase for Shell.
When your office is 200,000 acres of rugged woodland, and you train the men who prevent anything from happening to it, you can't depend on just any deodorant. Men count on Old Spice deodorant. It works to prevent odor, to neutralize it before it starts. There's nothing else this effective with the clean plastic scent of Old Spice. Old Spice deodorant, because prevention is the ultimate form of protection. Count on it.
The story of this game, very simple. Through three quarters, San Antonio has run for 219 yards. They're averaging 8.5 yards a running play.
We talked about at the top of the show, we talked about the injuries at quarterback, but I said the running game. San Antonio has run well. Raleigh-Durham has not stopped anybody this year. You stay with what has been successful for you so far tonight.
Well, as you just said, 8.4 yards average running on the ground. Roderick Graves is the running back behind Mike Johnson as the Riders put it in play. Second down and 8. And on a counter, Blake. That's under Johnson. And he is down near the 15 with a first down.
Mike Kizilak of the left guard pulled on that and led on that end around by Johnson. There was no one out there. He turned around to find Johnson. All of a sudden, Johnson's right behind him. Kizilak said, I better get going. So a first down at the Raleigh-Durham 16. Again, Graves, the lone setback. And he gets a look at that hole. And he's down near the 5, and it will be first and goal for the Riders.
I think it was Kizilak who I just talked to you about. He put Rafe Wilkinson. Talk about, here's a pancake. Watch number 98 in red. Here's the pancake. Your back. That's Kizilak, the left guard. That's a beautiful block, and that's what an offensive lineman lives for.
As you can see, Raleigh-Durham is going through that scenario for a defensive team. They're their secondary making all the plays. The up front people are not stopping.
And there's a San Antonio touchdown from Roderick Graves. And they're making it look easy. A dominant running game for San Antonio tonight, and they now lead 29-7.
Doesn't change on any level, Ted. If you can run the football, you got a great chance to win.
They've used three running backs tonight with great success. Blake, Johnson, and Graves. Well, here's Operation Discovery at work. Marco Rueda is on to kick the extra point. He is from Mexico, and this is his first professional football kick. And he got it through there.
Operation Discovery,
a worldwide search headed by John Ralston to find other athletes around the world who can play football, four of them on each World League team. San Antonio now leading 30-7.
The All-State Good Hands Play of the Week. Brought to you by Allstate. For home, auto, life, and business insurance, you're in good hands with Allstate. Montreal Machine cornerback Richard Shelton grabs this interception and goes 62 yards for a touchdown. And this week's Allstate Good Hands Play of the Week.
No one can guarantee you a perfect world. A world where the unexpected never intrudes. Snow will be taken care of quickly and compassionately. In an imperfect world, you're in good hands with Allstate, a member of the Sears Financial Network.
A company can learn a lot in 125 years. Valvoline has. You learn in the lab, you learn on the road, you learn on the racetrack. As you learn, you make your product better and better and better. Valvoline will keep your engine cleaner than ever before. And cleaner means more protection against engine wear. 125 years of quality. That's why people who know use Valvoline.
Skyhawks Skyhawks got close in the third quarter, but the Riders' ground game has made the difference.
Offensive line, right side of your screen, number 61, right tackle John Layfield seals it. And there's the touchdown. The offensive linemen, they start the running game.
And they're not going to let Marco Rueda kick off. It'll be Jim Gallery. Kicking it deep to Raleigh-Durham, Marvin Hargrove, and Pettis Samuel. And we have Operation Discovery out there right now. The kick receiving team for Raleigh-Durham.
There's a good drive.
But in the World League, you have to run it out of the end zone.
So here comes Hargrove.
Oh, baby! He is stone cold flattened by Terrence Hooks at the 20-yard line. And I hope he gets up from that.
Oh, baby, did you hear that up here? Counting his teeth right now.
Hey, I mean, better go and count his blessings.
He got up pretty fast. Holy mackerel. Number 50, Terrence Cook just comes down, meets him head on. Now, one correction, you don't have to run it out of the end zone, but if you don't, it comes out only to the 10-yard line.
You can kneel down in the end zone, but you don't get the touchdown.
Terrence Cook has made some shots tonight.
And so here now, Raleigh-Durham has gone to its backup quarterback, Joe Pizzo. And he cannot get the first play off in time.
And you can see what San Antonio is doing. They had like nine guys up on the line of scrimmage. You see that new quarterback, you say, let's go after him.
You can see Mars Hill, North Carolina, Joe Pizzo.
Play game, number six offense, still first down.
He's Operation Discovery of a different sort. Until a couple of weeks ago, he was managing a cellular telephone store owned by Roman Gabriel, and pressed into service here with the injury that the Skyhawks have suffered. So it is first and 15 now for Raleigh-Durham. Run a reverse, and Hargrove's going to pick up the bouncing ball. Once he does, he's got some blocking, and that's a first down run. That's a great play to call for a guy who just got his lights turned out on the kick cover return, huh? And Hargrove got it again.
Now, I don't think the design of this play is to dribble the ball, but a great shot right there. Just getting it off was good, and he gets a lucky bounce coming up into your hand. Look at Pizzo. He's going to try and block.
Let's see the shot here.
Plunk. He's going to come off with the help of a couple of the trainers. Is he smiling or squinting?
I have a feeling for the Skyhawks, human nature might dictate this becomes one of those nights where you might want to get out of there while you can. 13 minutes to play, 30-7 San Antonio. The Skyhawks have a first down. He's flushed out and throws it short. With Nicholson covering Clarkston Hines again.
We got some innovations here on Monday Night Football, right? There's the helmet cam. Who's wearing that thing?
Second down 10. Steve Grandoff. Good job, Steve. It's a lot less expensive, too, isn't it? Down it's dead.
They come.
Do something. Pizzo trying. Look at that. And you get a flag throwing. Pizzo.
A little face mask in there.
Yeah, he didn't go down easy.
He's fighting, struggling, and
trying to get some extra yardage. While they sort this out, we'll get an update from Diana Nyad in New York.
Ted, London is king at Legion Field tonight, top of the fourth quarter. Quarterback Sam Gelbaugh scrambles, escapes Darrell Phillips with no in the grass rule, and finds Andre Riley for 33 yards. It's London, 17-0. Let's go back to Ted Robinson.
All right, Diana, thank you. Sam Gelbaugh's been impressive, and London looks to be going 4-0.
Looks to keep pace with Barcelona. We'll be there in a couple weeks.
European circuit kicking off for USA. Second down here, and Pizzo drills to the far side and right through the hands. The ball should have been caught by Clarkston Hines.
Pizzo in from McAllister. McAllister taking some shots tonight. There he is on the sideline with a towel around his neck. It's been a very, very tough night for Mr. McAllister, but he has shown a lot of guts, I guess, by taking so many hits and keep popping up. Look at the rush here. Flag down. Pizzo got away. Trying to use one of the officials as a blocker. Surprised we haven't seen more holding calls tonight against Raleigh-Durham with all the pressure that the inside linebackers have put on the Raleigh-Durham offensive line.
Holding, number 68 offense.
Looking ahead, it's kind of nice to be able to look ahead and point at a game that could be interesting. London and Barcelona both undefeated. 4-0, their meeting this year comes in the season finale. They'll be playing May 27th at Wembley Stadium. Get your tickets. Rodrigue looking on. We have an injured Skyhawk player. USA brings you another world premiere movie. Patrick Cassidy uncovers a conspiracy to take over the White House and Hitler's daughter. Wednesday night at 9, 8 Central. A USA world premiere movie. And my correction, the injured player is a rider. It is Greg Ross. Last week suffered a dislocated jaw in a fight.
You know, watching that game in the first half last week, three or four players just in the first half alone walked off the field with assorted ailments, but they're all back here tonight.
Saw Roderick Manning went out with an elbow, and Ross, you said, with a jaw. Gardner went out with a knee. Gilbert went off with a nose, but they're all back. There are many who think that the fact that no contracts in the World League are guaranteed might have a lot to do with that. The eagerness to be back in action. This is no play, no pay. Or half pay, I guess we should be technical about it. For injured players in the World League.
Out of the gun on 3rd and 17.
Open down the middle. And the tight end, Sprinkles, cannot hang on as he got smacked by Anthony Cooney.
Another big hit.
Another man not getting up.
This has absolutely been a game of attrition tonight.
And I'm surprised there's not a flag on the field, because that time Cook rushing from the right side. He got tackled by Darryl McGill. Look at McGill, number 20. Cook's coming inside. He just hogties him. He could just barely see it, but no call. And now let's take a look at the hit. Clunk.
Now, not a fumble. Not a fumble. He must control the ball throughout, clearly touching both feet to the ground. Did not do that.
Well, when you throw a ball that far over the middle, it's got to have some mustard on it, or that receiver's going to get hit like that.
Sprinkles just joining this team.
He is another Team Dallas import just this week. And on 4th down and 15, the Skyhawks will be punting. Roy Fonce gets it away. Lee Morris, their catch.
With 10 minutes and 53 seconds
remaining in Raleigh, San Antonio, all over the Skyhawks, 30-7.
With every step, your child gets closer and closer to the problem of drug and alcohol abuse. Don't let it happen. Find out about drug abuse resistance education, or DARE America. It's an in-school program where community police officers teach kids how to say no to drugs the first time and every time. Support DARE America before your child gets too close to the edge. KFC is proud to be a national sponsor of DARE America.
The paint store in Gardendale Square has the expertise and paint for every job. Save now on quality DeVoe paints and finishes available in hundreds of stylish colors, like Wondertone Interior Latex Eggshell Enamel. Regularly $16.95 a gallon, it now will sell for $15.45. Or save $2 a gallon on Wondershield Exterior Acrylic Latex House and Trim Paint. Come to DeVoe Paint's Colors in Bloom sale at the paint store in Gardendale. They're in Gardendale Square, across from Sarah Chevrolet on Fieldstown Road.
You'll find the biggest savings of the year now at Premier Chevrolet Geo in Bessemer.
every car, truck, and van has been specially priced for this big premier sales event. You'll get all factory option package savings, all tax rebates, and factory to dealer incentives, plus gigantic premier sales discounts. And just for taking a test drive and getting our prize, we'll give you a 10-piece Anchor Hawking cookware set.
And by the way, ask about our bonus gift with each vehicle purchase at Premier Chevrolet Geo on the Bessemer Superhighway in Bessemer.
He seduced and betrayed them. Now they're getting even. Jack Scalia, Catherine Oxenberg, Ring of Scorpio, April 24th and 25th at 9.
San Antonio trying to keep pace with Sacramento in the North American West. Sacramento is 2-2 after beating Frankfurt Saturday. The Riders will be there if they close this out. Birmingham down to London tonight. They would fall to 1-3 if they lose. Mike Johnson staying in the game for the Riders. Drops the snap. First snap.
Almost looked like an option down the line, but he never got the ball. Now you'd have to start thinking maybe San Antonio would like to get a little help from Mickey Guidry, their backup quarterback in the game, keeping Johnson in here with the 23-point lead. Of course, now Johnson hasn't been here a long time. I'm sure they also want to get him a little experience as we look at Mike Riley, the head coach.
I'm sure the feeling behind that, Dave, in part is that Mickey Guidry may not be a Rider next week if Jason Garrett is healthy. Mickey Guidry might be back at Team Dallas. Johnson and Garrett being the two quarterbacks. Under a Johnson carries near first down, and let's go to Diana Nyad in New York.
Thanks, Ted. London on their way to 4-0. Stan Gelbaugh on a slant in hits Andre Riley for his second TD catch of the quarter. Could be a perfect night for London at 24-0. Let's go back to Ted Robinson.
Thank you, Diana. So it is looking like London will be 4-0. The Riders with Mike Johnson throwing it deep, and that one is caught by Bill Hatton.
Catch, but he never controlled that until he landed on his back out of bounds. So San Antonio catches a break. Had to be a mistake on the pattern because there were two receivers running down the left sideline. Well, they're catching all the breaks tonight. Now you watch it here on the sideline. From our angle, I didn't think he got it, but you see he's touching out of bounds. There's no way that's a catch.
Well, a lot of his body came in down inbounds. How do they judge that?
You know, if any part of his body is touching out of bounds, it's out of bounds.
But first down now at the 33 of Raleigh-Durham, and Graves gets the ball to the 25. Now right now you've got to feel a little bit for the Skyhawks. They're in the process of losing their second straight home game when they're in a real effort to bring professional football to this area. It's never been here before. It's one of the great growing areas of the country. And what you desperately need, what Roman Gabriel needs to do, is just to win a game to get the people here excited.
And what you'd like to do especially is win the games at home, because that's when your fans see you and that's when they're at the game.
Right now they'll be staring 0-2 at home. Graves again, look at the hole, and Broderick Graves is going to go in for another San Antonio touchdown. It has become a steamroll in Raleigh. I think the adjective was sweet. 36-7 for the Riders.
Good blocking right side of your screen. Mike Kislak seals down. Nice little hole there. Now missed tackles. We've seen them all night. Combination, excellent blocking, good running, and missed tackles. 36-7.
Marco Rueda. And he blasts through the extra point. 8:38 to play in Raleigh. San Antonio going home to beat Barcelona on a roll. 37-7.
I'm Dave Johnson. For my training for the 1992 decathlon, I switched to the pump from Reebok. When I'm pumped up, my feet have support, protection, and a custom fit for leaping, vaulting, spinning, jumping, sprinting, hurling, racing, running, throwing, and shot putting. Now I'm the guy who knows cross training. Pump up and air out.
Switch to the greatest sports performance shoe in the world, the Reebok Pump. Pump up and air out.
How far do you think it is?
Oh, about 140 miles.
And there ain't a thing out there.
Reliability isn't a sticker you put on the windshield. It's something you darn well better design in from the start.
This is forever.
You know, we're not selling these cars to mechanics. It could be someone like your mother, and they just gotta know they won't be left sitting somewhere by the side of the road.
I mean, that's the way I would want it if I was a customer. Hey, look at this.
Civilization.
Sort of.
How about a better hand soap?
Not us, we can't cope. We don't need no lava soap, no.
Regular soap won't always work, but lava with pumice will. Interested?
No, no, no.
Lava, but don't try to cope without it, soap.
In making an artistic statement, one's personal aroma shouldn't do the talking. So I use RightGuard Sport Stick with maximum protection. A true artiste should be known for inspiration, not perspiration. RightGuard Sport Stick. Anything less would be uncivilized.
The Barcelona Dragons go head-to-head with the San Antonio Riders. World League Football on USA. Saturday at 8 Eastern.
About 45 minutes ago, he was pretty excited. Right now, he is downcast as this team has been run over here in the fourth quarter. 37-7 for the Riders. Jim Gallery kicking again. Gerald Mack is now one of the deep backs. He's on the near side, the bottom of your screen for the Skyhawks. That'll be another kick to Hargrove. Marvin Hargrove from the 5-yard line. And he is just across the 20. The Skyhawks' defensive problems continue, and that's something that Roman Gabriel will have a tough time addressing this week, Dave, because they have a short week. They leave on Wednesday to go to Frankfurt just to have a couple of practices. And, you know, a lot of missed tackles tonight. They've been getting good blocking. San Antonio has an offensive line, but just too many missed tackles. Here's Darryl McGill getting outside. And he has a first down run across the 35. 285 yards rushing for San Antonio tonight. Ricky Blake over 100. Broderick Graves, who came into the game third team on their depth chart. Broderick Graves has run for 96 yards. And it's a pretty easy night for Mike Riley. And from behind, Pizzo, sacked by Roderick Manning. Well, Operation Discovery, that is Vladimir Georgiev from Moldavia in the Soviet Union, 21 years old. He played for the Moscow Bears football team.
And on that last kickoff return, he had to block number 50, Terrence Cooks, and, well, he didn't quite get him.
There's an incompletion, but just to show you that the cultural differences are not as great as many may think, you know what Vladimir Georgiev's favorite thing is? Rap music. MC Hammer in Moscow. That's Oleg Sapego, who was a rugby player in Moldavia.
Third down and 16.
Served some time in the Soviet Army.
That'll be an interesting experience for them coming over here.
They've been playing on special teams, both of them, the last 2 weeks for Raleigh-Durham. Joe Pizzo has another pass tipped by Tim Walton. And so on fourth down, Troy Fouts will come on to punt again for the Skyhawks with 7 minutes remaining. A busy night for Troy Fouts, beginning with his very first punt being blocked out of his own end zone for a safety. And Fouts, that's his best punt of the night. Morris with a fair catch at the 22-yard line for San Antonio. You look at what's happened this week in the World League, and a big weekend. Scott Ernie to Gene Taylor with a great combination for Barcelona.
How about Orlando having a tough time across the Atlantic Ocean?
Now how about Kubani Colombo, a first-team All-Samoan in college? The winning score for the Sacramento Surge. And the run and shoot got going.
They did. Had a few problems, but 44 points up in Montreal. Big win.
Big game for Jeff Graham, the Knights quarterback. As Ricky Blake gets the call for San Antonio. You made an interesting point a little while ago, Dave, that maybe some of the theorists will chew on over the next few weeks.
it has been difficult for the American teams. No American team has gone over to Europe and won a game yet, but the European teams have had no problem playing North America.
You know why? I think you have traveled, I've traveled, any of you out there have traveled. When you go east a long distance, it's tougher because you lose the day. When you come west, you're still in that same day, and it doesn't seem as tough, so I think that's helped those teams.
Put a little rush on here. Paul Palmer's early World League rushing record of 133 yards. Well, Mickey's got his helmet on. Mickey Gidry, the backup quarterback.
Don't know if he was told to put it on or if he's just getting hopeful.
Another reason why Mickey Gidry may not be playing, he backed up Tommy Hodgson at LSU, but he had only been at Team Dallas for 2 days. He was a very late signee to the World League. Only 2 days at Team Dallas before joining the Riders a week ago. Very little practice time. Ricky Blake. You've been on enough football teams, Dave, to know that when you get in this kind of situation, the starter's going to get all the snaps because he needs to work in practice.
3-25! 3-21! Now, talking to Mike Johnson yesterday, trying to just get some of the play calls from him, most teams will go with, when they're running plays, they'll go with a two-number system, they'll go with a passing play, they go with a three-number system. He told me both running and passing, they go with the three numbers, so you can't pick it up. The other teams can't pick it up.
3-7-48!
Three numbers, you'd think it'd be a pass. That's why it's tough to pick up. And he said, with all the microphones and people listening, we had to go to more of a memorization type of thing rather than just a descriptive type of terminology, which is what most teams use. But the, you know, with the microphones picking up everything here, more stuff gets out. Earlier in the game, I think it was Raleigh-Durham calling a 38, a toss 38. Well, that's just a toss around the right side.
3-56! 3-9-80!
First and 10, San Antonio. Blake has gone well past Paul Palmer's 133-yard game last week. And so Ricky Blake, who played 2 years of junior college, that's really all his college experience, now the single-game World League rushing leader. 21 carries, 146 yards. 144 yards. We're unofficial. But it's a record nonetheless for Ricky Blake.
1-3-40!
And I would believe that also make him the World League rushing leader after 4 weeks. Blake again. The Riders are doing a good job of running the clock out here. Down to 3 minutes to play now. Raleigh 37-7. Unfortunately, it is down to the dearest of family and friends at Carter Finley Stadium.
You know, I asked Ricky Blake yesterday at practice. I said he'd like to get the ball about 25 times a game. He said, yeah, I would, but I probably won't. Well, he's close today.
Johnson inside the 35. We mentioned how difficult this is for the Skyhawks. Roman Gabriel, the owner of the Skyhawks, is George Shinn, the man that brought professional basketball to the state of North Carolina with the Charlotte Hornets. And he is fighting very hard to make North Carolina a professional sports hotbed. One of the owners of the Riders is Tom Landry. He is not on this trip, but was present in San Antonio last Sunday when the Riders got their first win. And under Johnson carries again, and that'll get us to 2 minutes. Actually, a bit under 2 minutes remaining in Raleigh, North Carolina. It's San Antonio tonight, running their way to a big win.
From Gillette comes Sensor, the only razor that can sense and adjust to the individual needs of your face.
Sensor blades are mounted on responsive springs to continuously sense and individually adjust to your face. The closest, safest, most comfortable Gillette sensor, together with the richness of foamy shave cream for the best shave a man can get.
Isn't Sir John late for tea?
Yes. I rather think he is. Rather. Jolly good cup of tea, Perkins.
Now no one is safe from American football. KFC introduces the World League Challenge Sweepstakes. You could win $1 million instantly or over 10 million other prizes, including delicious Kentucky Fried Chicken. So rush into your local KFC restaurant and play today. Good luck, huge.
Single game World League rushing high. Ricky Blake is our KFC player of the game tonight. KFC will donate $1,000 in Ricky Blake's name to DARE, Drug Abuse Resistance Education.
You know, talked to Ricky yesterday. They had a rough flight coming in from San Antonio, a little turbulence. He told me he's going to rent a car and drive back to San Antonio.
Believe it or not, the Riders are the only World League team that charters. They have their own charter airplane, and they are going to be leaving right after the game tonight. There, Andre Johnson brought down. David Ammons making the play for the Skyhawks. And that'll force a fourth and long here for the Riders.
40.
Looks a little wet, doesn't it? Here's the end around to Johnson, but 93 left side. I'm sorry, 73 right there with a shot. David Adams. 125 remaining. The Riders will go for it here on fourth down and 12. And we'll just hand it up the middle, and Andre Johnson rambles. Well, he is going to be about 2 yards shy. So the Skyhawks will get the ball back one last time with a minute and 13 seconds remaining. Mike Johnson walks off the field 2-0 as a starting quarterback. And Joe Pizzo will get one more chance. But that's got to feel good. Well, he's been in the starting lineup 2 weeks. He's got two W's. Mike Johnson getting a chance. That's what this league's all about. Left-hander, a sprint outer in college. It's not easy to get that chance. And so he will present Mike Riley with an interesting dilemma somewhere along the line. With Jason Garrett is healthy again. Darryl McGill, the ball carrier for Raleigh-Durham, that's a first down. You know, Jason Garrett may have been the starter, but this guy has gotten a couple of W's there. I think you got to stay with a hot hand. Pizzo, well, the man wide open down the field. Larkston Hines, and he dragged two people down just shy of the goal line. Marked out of bounds inside the one. Well, you talk about a prevent defense. What you prevent are the long bombs. There was a prevent defense that didn't work. Clarkson Hines is getting wide open down the right sideline. A breakdown. And Raleigh-Durham calling the timeout with 43 seconds left. All right, here we go. 37-7. Let's say they score the touchdown. Go for two. 37-15. Onside kick. All right. One pass for a touchdown, 2 points. Why are you looking at me funny?
Roman will go for two, though.
There's another Operation Discovery player who was in on that play. 41 is John Hillier, Mark. He is half Swedish, half Nigerian. A junior boxing champ who valets cars in the offseason. And now this day and age, professional sports, do you know anybody who valets cars in an off-season line of work? Mike Riley looks a little wet. They gave him the Gatorade dumping, or the Gatorade bath during our last commercial. There's John Hillier, Mark. Learned enough about American football to wear a mask. Did he park our car before the game? 43 seconds here, and the Skyhawks give it to Pizzo, and he sneaks it in. Well, in a lost cause, that is a very nice reward for Joe Pizzo. Somewhere in the stands tonight are probably some friends of Joe Pizzo's who never thought they'd get a chance to see him. That might be them. That's not all that's left that would have a chance to see him score a touchdown. Now here in the World League, they put the ball on the 3-yard line. The extra point. Shifting, they put Joe Merton in the tight end right behind Pizzo. On the try for two. And it's good. A little flip to Darryl McGill. So the Skyhawks convert a two-point play. 41 seconds remaining. It is now a 37-15 lead for San Antonio. Now, do you think they'll try the outside kick here? I think they practiced it. Hey, they're going to try it. Well, one thing, it's the first time they'll have had a chance to use it in a game. The Skyhawks have not scored too many points in their first four games. We'll be back for the conclusion in Raleigh, North Carolina in just a moment.
Today, a guy losing his hair can choose between being the man he wants to be.
You look great with hair. Do something to save it.
And the man he could become.
Can't you accept nature like everyone else?
Doctors have hair loss treatment programs that are proven to work. And the sooner you see a doctor, the better.
We don't want nature. We want hair.
When you've considered the arguments,
we might look great bald.
And you decide you want hair. There's only one thing to do. See your doctor. Or call this number for more information.
Mr. Jones has gone without HBO comedy for 27 days.
They shoot, he scores! Hello, home jumpers! A new car!
This has resulted in acute channel switching nervosa. HBO's uncut comedy with major stars at maximum hilariosity stimulates the laugh lobes and excites the giggles majora. Without HBO, this syndrome can result.
Our next contestant, this is a test!
Tragic.
HBO comedy, simply the best.
Oh, the San Antonio Riders are going to tie Sacramento for first place in the North American West. Milton Hoyle making sure he has 10 people alongside him to try to field his onside kick. Now, what you try and do, you see, obviously he's going to set it over here, kick it towards this way. You want to top it so it bounces, and just before it gets to the San Antonio front line, it pops up in the air. Usually the second bounce would be the high one, right? Well, it depends on if he sends it flying along. Granted, I could kick it back left side. One, two, and up. That's what you hope. And that one took a high hop into the hands of Bill Hess. You know what I've seen him do, too, is bring everybody over here on this side and have them adjust, have San Antonio adjust everybody over. Then he kicks it back to the left side. I've seen that, too. So you just have to get the lucky bounce in a sense because you can't control the football. Well, an awfully impressive finish for the London Monarchs in Birmingham. They shut out the Fire tonight. And London joins Barcelona at 4-0 in the European division. You know, the World Bowl is going to be at Wembley Stadium, so that'd be a big coup for London if they could get into that game and play in their home park. How about the poor Frankfurt Galaxy at 2-2? They're looking at maybe a near impossible task to make the World League playoffs. Another division, and the other two divisions, they would have a good shot.
The three division winners go, plus the next team with the best record.
One wild card team. And the Riders will not have to put the ball in play again. They didn't restart the play clock mercifully, and that's going to put an end to it. Mike Riley got soaked a few minutes ago. There's some happy Texans. And San Antonio with an awfully impressive night. They're cracked at the undefeated Barcelona Dragons next Saturday night in a game that you'll see right here in USA at Alamo Stadium. 37-15 for the Riders tonight. And Ricky Blake, the new single-game rushing leader in the first 4 weeks of the World League season. Somebody has to have that record. It's now Ricky. Over 140 yards on the ground tonight. Antonio. 37, Raleigh-Durham 15. We'll come back to say goodnight. Carter-Finley Stadium in just a moment.
Because if you don't watch your figure, who will?
It's the right feeling now.
Because when it comes to water, the only place to start is at the top.
It's the right feeling now.
Because when the party's going full steam, you don't want to fill up. So reach for the beer that won't blow you down. The Silver Bullet.
Cool, it's the right feeling now.
You've arrived when you're customized. Clothes, clubs, bags, but only one golf shoe gives every golfer a custom fit now that the pump from Reebok has arrived. I pump up for support, protection, and a custom fit. So before you tee up, pump up. Oh, and Curtis, don't be so strange. Pump up and air out.
Switch to the greatest sports performance shoe in the world, the Reebok Pump. Pump up and air out.
Isn't Sir John late for tea?
Yes. I rather think he is. Rather. Jolly good cup of tea, Perkins.
Now no one is safe from American football. KFC introduces the World League Challenge Sweepstakes. You could win $1 million instantly or over 10 million other prizes, including delicious Kentucky Fried Chicken. So rush into your local KFC restaurant and play today. Good luck, huge!
Behind a big night from Ricky Blake, San Antonio runs to an impressive win over Raleigh-Durham. And the Riders have won two straight. Next Saturday, Raleigh-Durham at Frankfurt. 2 Eastern, live 11 Pacific. Barcelona at San Antonio next Saturday night. And next Monday, Sacramento at the New York-New Jersey Knights. With Dave Jennings, I'm Ted Robinson. Good night from Raleigh.